too much. I think they're too big. I got these from Shady Rays. I don't think they fit my face shape. I know, they're so big. Well, they had something that was like... Whoops. They had something that was like... It was like $5, and they'll give you a free pair. No, not free. $5, and they give you a pair of the things, like a random pair of these glasses. And now I feel stupid. I feel so dumb. They're so big. Look at that. You see this? I don't have the face shape for this. Yeah, I think we go cringe confessional. Yeah, these are new. But you guys could see my screen. I don't like that. I don't like you guys being able to peer into my most secret third monitor secrets. I got shit over there, dude. There's some shit over there that you'll never see. Let me take these off before I get in trouble. Hey, y'all. I'm not a geek. Shut up. You're a geek. This stream is sponsored, by the way, so that should be nice. Happy Wednesday! Hey, sorry I didn't stream yesterday. Something came up. Something happened, so I didn't stream. Hope you guys had a wonderful Tuesday. But now we're going to have a wonderful Wednesday. And I didn't get the crown bounty, and I don't know why. I don't know why they didn't give me the crown bounty this time. I did so well the last time.
The priest lost yesterday, Sag.
He did not, did he? His ass is losing, bro. I didn't fail the bounty. I don't think you can fail the bounty. I didn't even say, well, simply failed the bounty. He was a little bit too aggressively critical, let's say. Bounty flop? My bounty popped off. My bounty was good. Who was Fox in the ad? Nobody you know. It's my friend Eric. The guy that made that Lammy video that is that now has apparently 60,000 views. That was Fox. We filmed it in his backyard. So, I actually, in case you guys didn't see it, you guys hear the Silk Song news? Oh, we're talking about it. Oh, we're definitely going to talk about it. So, on today's movie, I don't know if you guys saw it yet. If you didn't, that's okay. I know you're going to get to it. We had an ad for the Gel Blaster Surge. This here. Yeah, it's a toy. I don't know why I keep getting these. Hold on. I still got it here. Dude, this shit shoots fast and hard. Watch this. Did you see it? I shot you. Did you see it? Hold on, let me do... It's not... Okay, It's raining stuff on me. I don't know if you see it. But it's very hard. I did it on my hand, and it made a welt. So you gotta stand pretty far away. I shouldn't be giving them promo. Anyway, they were like, we want a promo on your YouTube. I was like, really? What is this, Nickelodeon? And I was going to do like a big over-the-top 90s ad. And then I realized that it said that I had to do it with another person. And I was like, oh. And I called up my buddy Eric. And I was like, hey, you want to do this? He was like, yeah. And then he edited it, which is why it's so fantastically edited. And then I asked him to roll around in some poison ivy. And he did it. So there you go. Yep. Got itchy all over for a couple days. But you know what? It's the love of the art and the money, because they paid me money to do this. But he didn't get any because he was the Fox. I could have found anybody to be Fox. You know what I mean? Check out this full auto.
This switch on the back of the blaster, we could send our gelets into overdrive. Take this, foul beast.
Okay, I don't know if you guys could see it here. I was shooting it right at blasting. I'm not allowed to say shooting. I was blasting it right at him, right there. And I was like, are they going to be mad at me for this? Because, like, you know, I'm... You're not supposed to shoot somebody in the face. He had this fox head somewhere, by the way. He just had it laying around. And then I killed him. Yeah. He's wearing goggles and a mask. Dude, it was one of those things where we were like, is the mask enough? No, we should wear the I legitimately thought they were going to be mad at me. I thought they were going to be like, dude, what the fuck? Why did you make that? Go make a different one. But, hey, they were into it. I was like, oh, hell yeah. That's what the point of the mask is, though. True. Yeah. I forgot about that. I did hear a song about that once, yeah. But no, it was awesome. It was a lot of fun. It was good. I had something else. Oh, yeah. Hold on. Check this shit out. Leon Watch. Damn, it's number 7. Dude, oh my god. Wait, I literally just took a picture. Wait. No way. I literally just sent this to Leon Massey like 10 minutes, like right before I went live. It was at 197. Now it's at 198. It's getting up there. So it has to be, like, this is like the Mortal Kombat Tower, Smash 4 Customs, Bayonetta, Smash FGC, Multiverses, which I don't think is trending anytime soon. The HBox video, and then the final boss for some reason, which is Wheelchamp. I don't know why Wheelchamp is the final boss. A little weird, but... Yeah. I didn't think this thumbnail was good. I'm shocked it hit. But it's doing good. So, FGC content good. Dude, I have so many ideas for Street Fighter 6, but they all require me going to the same tournaments as Street Fighter people who are not at Evo. I might go to Evo just to shoot shit. 98 months! Dude! In 1 month, we'll have had 11 babies. Did you ever think about that? You and me, 11 babies. You and I. Oh my god. Old as hell. You guys don't think of... No, I don't think of that. You don't? You don't think that way? You don't think of subs in 9 month increments? Stream babies? No. Me and Ella Fox have a big happy family. Anybody in chat younger than 98 months? How old is that? 12 times 5 is 60. 6 is 72. 7 is 84. Might be 1. 8.5? 8 years, 2 months. Damn, there might be. There might be a single 8-year-old in here. Hey, don't out yourself. You'll get banned. 8-year-old, just stick... Hey, 8-year-old, I got a great product for you. It's called the Joe Blaster Surge. Pick it up at any store or use code CODY10 to get 10% off your order. $50. This thing has full auto, too. Check this shit out. You can't even see it. Why am I doing that? I just blasted the whole back wall. You can't even fucking see it. I'm gonna shoot you again. Did you see it? I want to get the lens. Gotcha. That's a very expensive lens. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, that's a DSLR. Hold on.
Hold on.
How do I clean it? How do I clean that? Can I use paper towels? Microfiber? Hold still, okay? Is that better? Is that... Oh, damn! I look good! What the fuck? I should have done that a while ago. That looks much better. eyes cleaned. That looks great. I think. Is that? I'm looking for like spots. I think we're good. I did not miss a spot. It looks good. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the stream. I hope you got this song is long and chaotic. I hope you guys are having a wonderful Wednesday. Thanks, Motobug. Motobug, your name came up on the GG Melee podcast I was on. I don't know if you guys saw it. I was on an episode of Radio Melee, Golden Guardians, and they said, do you think PM could ever come back? And I said, nah. Nope. Not ever. But thank you for asking. I was a little bit more eloquent than that. Bro hates PM? Yep, that's me. Nintendo. Nintendo. I just don't know. I don't know how PM gets bigger. Because, like, Nintendo's always going to be, like, over your shoulder like this, right? They've done it before. I'll do my best to get PM back. Godspeed, soldier. If you have any paid gigs, give me a call. I'm down to fight for the cause. Not really, but I'll be a mercenary. Just pay me to get out there. Let's do it together. Come on, guys. Grassroots. Why is it that you're always streaming on days I go to church? How much do you go to church? You go to church every Sunday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday? Always? God can wait one day, right? It's not that big a deal. All right, so tonight we got a couple things. I wanted to check out this new Fall Guys update. I don't know if I want to play it. Oh yeah, I have news for you. First, let me make the hold on. I gotta make the tweet first.
What's up, fellas? And today we're watching Watch Mojo, the 10 top dog breeds.
I would watch it, but I don't think that exists. I'm trying to find a good Kickstarter.
Who's your favorite Honkai Impact character, Connie? Is it Himiko?
Yeah, I love Himiko. It's definitely Himiko. Big fan of Himiko, I think. Is that okay? Same? Okay. Is that okay? Am I allowed to... Are they bad? Is that allowed? Hold on, I need a picture of a shitty Kickstarter to tweet. The worst one ever. Oh, here we go. Licky cat. Lick your cat. Lick your cat like a cat with the licky brush. That's what it's called. You guys have seen that, right? Have you guys not seen the licky brush? Yeah, bro. Okay. All right, tweets out. Yeah, you guys haven't seen this? You put it in your mouth and you can lick your cat like the cats do. Which is probably good for them. I don't know if anybody has any science on that. Do I have any vets in the audience? Rip Bernie. Wait. It's a meme, right? Okay. Yeah, everybody. Yeah, okay. Very funny. Very silly indeed. Okay. You ever bite your dog? Not hard. Not hard. Not hard. Gently. Like they bite you and you gently like... Never? Oh no, me neither. I would never do that. That's so weird. That would be so weird to do. Why would you do that? They'd just be confused, right? In a playful way? No, not... Yeah, yeah, in a play... Like I wouldn't do it, but if I did, it'd be like in a playful way. Like I was kidding, right? Like, I was trying to communicate with it, but I didn't do that. Just wanted to know if you did. There was somebody in here that ground pounded once in real life to try to get a star. So, you know, I thought you guys were into weird behaviors. But the weirdest behavior of all is not subscribing to the channel. Ads are coming. You can't stop them. Not even Jeff Bezos can stop them. They keep rushing in, and he tries to hold them back, but they're going to break through. Subscribe to Twitch Prime. It's a free way to subscribe to the stream. Otherwise, you're going to get ads for Acura and Hyundai, and you can't afford that right now. Here they come. Ah! Thank you, Hidden Llama. Is 20 months good? I don't know. 20 months? Not 21? Not 20 gifted? Come on. Thanks, Vaporverse. Thanks, Zach Tacko. Thank you. Oh, I don't know what that is. Get smoked free two watchers. I don't know how to say that. Thanks, Limp. I ruptured my appendix as a kid by ground pounding real life. I'm not kidding. I was in the hospital that week. We have found our second ground pounder in the Coney stream. Congratulations. That's the second person that has admitted to ground pounding in real life. Where's your appendix? Would that shit blow up? Appendix. Is appendixes are like not needed, right? It's like wisdom teeth. This? Can I show this? It's intestines. I could show this. It's medicinal. Ew. Ugh. It's the bit off your intestine. It's so gross. You thought the star was in your appendix and you had to break it open. Where's the wait, how come I can't find it? Oh, this one. Yay! No, the Odyssey one. How come that's so hard to find? How do you find the Odyssey sound? The Odyssey sound is way funnier. Oh. Thanks, Whimsicott. Look it up. I did. Mario Odyssey Star Get. That one's way funnier. Oh, they're moons. Right. Tough. I forgot. Whoops. Thank you, Torbjorn. Do the sunshine one? That's the one with the whoo-hoo-hoo. There is nothing more pleasing to me than Nintendo's fascination with the whoo instrument during the GameCube. It was like that in Mario Kart. There's a lot of hooing going on. So, I don't know if you guys know this, but kids, when they hit a certain age, they start going through a phase, okay? And my daughter's going through a phase right now. First, she said no to everything. It's when kids find out that they have a choice in something, so they'll start saying no all the time. But now, instead of no, she starts saying, I can't. To everything. All right, Juliet, let's put on our shoes and go outside. I can't. Yes, you can. You can. All right, let's brush your teeth before you go to bed. I can't. It's literally for everything. All right, do you want to eat? Let's go eat lunch. I can't. You can. You will. Asked her if she wanted to take a bath tonight. I can't. It's just, and I don't know why that's a phase that I have to go through, but as a streamer, it's miserable. Also, I got a lot of stories today. I went into the dentist today, right? I got my teeth cleaned today, and my wife, this is a new dentist, and I had to go through the whole procedure. My wife has been bragging to our dentist about my job, and like he's like, oh, so you're a YouTuber, you're a big video influencer. I'm like, oh fuck me, because it's not like an Uber driver, right? That's my fucking dentist. And he was like, hey, so what is it you play Minecraft, right? And normally I would just let that rock. I'd be like, yeah, Minecraft, sure. But I couldn't do that because he's going to see me again because I need some fillings. I was like, all right, yeah, Smash Bros, actually. He's like, oh, I don't know that. I play Call of Duty. I'm like, this is just like my fucking Ubers. Okay. He's like, yeah, I play Call of Duty, but I stopped because I was in college and I was getting destroyed by 12-year-olds and being yelled at. I was like, I get it. Yeah. He's in college for dentistry and he's going 0-48. So, the hygienist, not the dentist, but the hygienist started talking to me about how her sons really love gaming and they love YouTube and Twitch. And they're like, oh, I bet they know about you. I'm like, I don't think they do. I was like, lady, I'm not a celebrity. I'm not like PewDiePie or something. But she did say that her sons knew Smash Brothers. And I think that I'm fucked now. I'm a little worried now because, right? Like, they're starting to zero in on my location. Apparently, they were talking about pro Smash players at some point, so I might have been found out. I might get 20 questions. So, very humble, Coney, to be honest. Oh, yeah, you think so? I had 100K subs on YouTube, and I start getting all Hollywood. Oh, yeah, I'm huge. Actually, in the YouTube ranking, I'm like number 97,852 in all-time sub rankings. So, you know, top 100K. Ain't no thing. About to have the cleanest teeth of all time just to avoid further interaction. Okay, so two things. One, I gotta get my wisdom teeth out. Two, she was like, you wanna get that underbite fixed? And I'm like, oh shit. What would that take? And she said, surgery. I said, I'm good. I'm not doing that shit. I'm leaving that shit alone. My ass will not be surgerized. I'm keeping this forever. Wisdom teeth removals, hell yeah. You still have your wisdom teeth? Yeah. So my mouth is big enough that I don't have to get rid of them. But they're they're getting cavities and shit, and we're just gonna drop them. So, yeah. Kind of toxic of her, to be honest. Dude, the way she was talking to me, she was like, yeah, your gums look good. The bone looks good. All your nerve is oh my goodness. It was like that SpongeBob thing. He's like, oh, you ever get that looked at? I'm like, what? Said that bite. I'm like, I know. It's an underbite. Come on. I didn't always have this. It was only in the last, like, I don't know, 10 years maybe? I don't know when it came out. My jaw just starts. It's more and more Chad-like. Speaking of Chad-like, wait a minute. Bro, hold on. We haven't talked in a little bit. We have much to discuss. Dude, I am so fucking happy people are laughing at this show. Mallory loves trash TV. She loves this stupid show, and she always has. She loved this show, and I was like, this show is fucking crazy. I was like, sweetie, this show is nonsense. She loves the weirdest shit. I also have never liked this actor. This actor is Freddie Highmore, who is also the kid in Willy Wonka, which people didn't know until recently for some reason. But yeah, for some reason, I have an aversion to Freddie Highmore. I don't know why. I think it's because back in the day when he was a kid, whenever he acted, he would do like a little whispery British voice. It's very whispery. Candy doesn't have to have a point. That's why it's Ken. It's like that, right? And I hated his voice. And now he did this show, and Mallory watched this whole show. And she's like, oh, it's sweet. I feel bad for him. And I kept siding with this fucking guy the whole time. I'm like, yeah, that guy can't control his emotions. I understand he has issues, but if he's going to be cutting people open, maybe he should work on them and we should take a little bit of time. He's only like 22. Give him more time. I was a Dr. Han fan. And now the whole internet seems to be on my side, and I'm very happy for that. I am so glad that the internet has come around to this show. It is nonsense. Good acting, though. Yeah, he cried his heart out. Yeah, I mean, Freddy's kind of killing it here.
I am a surgeon! Dr. Han!
He's killing it, actually. He believes it, right? I am so glad this show is getting the recognition it deserves for being fucking bonkers. Mal loved this show. I watched one episode with her. I was like, honey, I can't. I can't stomach anymore. It was crazy. It was bad. Couple of other things. Wait a minute. Hold on. Guys. Never ever. Never. Never ever. Not happening. Silk Song and yup. That shit is dead. They just don't want to make you sad. They don't want to tell you that. Game's not real. That long to make a 2D Metroidvania? I actually can't. You kidding me? Lazy and greedy devs. I literally can't. How long do you think Metroidvanias take? I don't, 3 months? It's a little bit too much. A little bit too much pepper on that one. A year? It's 2D! An update from the dev team with no footage or even a screenshot. We got nothing, Big Matt? Nothing, Matt? Dang. That shit's vaporware. Tough. This guy waited 7 years for 3 Cuphead bosses. I really am bitter. I beat that shit in a night. I asked all of those in like 3 hours. Miserable. Stupid. It was nice and all, but fuck, man. They weren't even hard, man. That's what I'm saying. They weren't even that difficult. Ah. Expect more details when details are developed. Expect more updates when we make the game. Soon. Definitely soon. Yeah. Don't worry. It'll happen. How long did Cuphead base game take? Oh, dude. An absurd amount of time. The Cuphead first build, I think it got revealed in like 2006. And it came out in like 2014, 2015, 2016, I don't remember. 16? 17? It came out in a really good year. Maybe not 2006, but it came out in 2017, okay. 17 was a really good year. I remember early Cuphead footage because I saw it on sites, and I was like, oh my god, this looks amazing, and I kept up with it. And I was like, okay, this is either going to die or it's going to be bad. And then it was good. It's rare that a game comes out that people are waiting for forever. But that game did it. Psychonauts 2 also, which... oh, so good. Psychonauts 2 was so good. I hope that, I hope Hollow Knight is good. I like the first Hollow Knight a lot, but... I thought Pizza Tower was going to suck too. I thought Pizza Tower was going to be, how do I put this? One of those games that people like because it's cool and trendy to like because it's underground and hipster more than it's actually good. You know what I mean? But it's fantastic. It's so good. Hey, did you guys see this? Wait, did they delete it? What? No way they deleted it. You guys see the IGN video? That's crazy. Yeah, IGN basically came out and said, like, they're like, why do you give so many sevens for your games? They're like, well, you know, a 7 is just kind of middle of the road. There's a billion games. If it's good, it's a 7. Deal with it. If we don't review your game, it's either not good enough or not popular enough. Eat shit. And I was like, okay, sick. A 7 for me is good. Because if I have an indie game and it gets a 7, I'm like, that is exactly the game that it looks like it is, right? How many times are there indie games that it looks good and then you, like, Skatebird. Skatebird looks fantastic. It's like, oh, this is a really cool idea. And then you play it, you're like, oh, this is kind of empty, right? Games catch your eyes like cereal boxes. If an IGN gives it a 7, it's basically saying the cereal that this looks like is in the box. And you won't find any other bullshit, right? No metal blades. Or secret $100 bills. It does exactly what it says it's going to do. If you're a AAA game and you get a 7, though, that's an L. You should be doing better. That's not good. They phrase it in a way that implies that underground games are bad. Yeah, and it's rage bait, and it worked. They had to delete the tweet. Maybe it worked a little too well. maybe it's a little bit too strong. But yeah. But no, they're right. What, 10,000 games on Steam last year? Fuck no, they're not reviewing all of them. I stand with IGN. So, somebody who I like, one of my friends was like, yeah, but this basically is them saying that they aren't a game review site. They're a media marketing site. I was like, yeah. I don't think you needed them to tell you that. What would you rate your stream out of 10? Oh, dude, like 100. 500, actually. 500 is what I would rate it. I think like 500. I think we should put it to a poll in the chat, actually. Chat, what do you guys think? Hold on. Here we go. Hold on. No, I'll poll it. I'll poll it.
Grade you could get. Anything worse could be so bad it's good, and anything higher is just good.
Hold on. What would you rate the Coney stream out of 10? Go ahead and cast your vote in the poll. 7.3, too much mojo? I haven't mojoed in forever! I haven't mojoed in so long? Are you kidding? Come on! 4 or 5 is the worst grade you could get. Anything worse could be so bad it's good, and anything higher is just good. Yeah, if something gets like a 3, it's a spectacle. If I see a game get a 3, I'm like, ooh. But Redfall got a 4, and I'm like, ugh. I'm not playing that. No way I'm doing that shit. I think a 4 is the worst one. Was it the last mojo like 3 weeks ago or so? I try to do it once every 2 or 3 or 4 weeks. Yeah. I'm trying to, my ult is not charged yet. You know what I mean? Damn, it looks like it's a 10. It's a 10 from the viewing public. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate it. Thanks for the 10, the vote of confidence. Out of 100. Shut up. You bastard. Oh, like a YouTube 10. No, 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 no. No, no, like a Twitch 10. Woohoo. Like 10 viewers. Haha. I already made it. There you go. Funny. All right. So, we got some stuff we're going to do tonight. And it should be a good time. Is the new Fall Guys... Has anybody looked at it? Is there a, Is the new Fall Guys, like, is it like Kaizo? Can you, like, Mario make it? It's good. It's mid. Oh, wait, I forgot to mention. Hold on. I do have something to announce.
Penguins would force...
Wait, Elfox said, I like the IGN vid because it reminded me of this. What is this? I don't know what this is. I've never seen anything like this.
Minecraft to change forever.
That's useless.
But tell me, okay, what's the first thing that...
Penguins would force Minecraft to change forever.
That's useless.
But tell me, okay, what's the first thing that comes to mind when you think about penguins?
Snow golems.
Stop. The penguin would be the only mob that you can tame using a sword.
What are you talking about?
In real life, the female penguin lays the eggs, but the father is in charge of keeping it safe. So, if you encounter an egg in the snow biome, you have a chance to protect it from hostile mobs. If it hatches, it'll become your pet.
This isn't the podcast, right? They have the podcast meta down where you pretend you're doing a podcast.
Just as useless as a polar bear.
It's one of the fake podcasts.
It would have two of the most valuable abilities. In the wild, a penguin uses the Earth's magnetic field.
Is this how we teach children about animals?
To know exactly where it's at in the ocean.
Oh my god, thank you, Slurpus, for the raid. Sorry, I just saw that.
But in Minecraft, if you ever get lost, the penguin would lead you back home. In second, it'll be able to catch multiple fish at a time.
This is not Madagascar. Plus, we would need an Arctic biome.
So that's the end. Okay. Dude, I want to start a fake podcast TikTok. That would be a lot of fun. You'd be amazed by how many kids are learning new stuff through TikTok. Dude, the TikTok like podcast format is fascinating to me. I can't believe that's like a trend now. Okay, so one more thing. One last thing before we get started. Fellows and fellettes. I will be competing in the Twitch Rivals Fall Guys Creative Launch NA. This Friday, we're getting the band back to getting the band back together. It's me, Alpha Rad, Dylan Deezus, and Bobby Wasabi. We're a team of 4, and we're getting back together. Unfortunately, we couldn't get Minecraft Matthew. We're going to be playing in Twitch Rivals on Friday, all right? Now, I'm a little rusty, as is everybody on the team. They all said they haven't played at all, but we're going to see how things go. Yeah, Matthew has, like, a real job. He's got, like, a cringe 9-to-5. So while he works, we're going to be gaming. So we're going to be playing this on Friday, which means probably no stream tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe. We'll see how things go. But I might stream Saturday, because that's when... it depends on Low Tide City. I'm watching Low Tide City this weekend, but I don't know when. So we'll see. We'll figure it. The streams will be all over the place. Tears of the Kingdom Day. Good luck with that. Fuck. I forgot. Listen, leave the stream open. Would you? Would you leave the stream open? Would you? Yeah, hey, the Switch is mobile, right? The Switch is... Oh, I forgot. Come on, bro. Don't you want to watch some Fall Guys gaming? Tears of the Kingdom category? I'm literally in a Twitch event. I think they would ban me for that. I'm in a Twitch event. That's tough. Nobody wants to watch Zelda because they don't want to spoil it for themselves. I don't think that's true. Nobody wants to watch me play Zelda because they don't want to spoil. I can't play AAA games. I tried it with Elden Ring. I tried it with a couple different games. But, like, my stream is not the trick. But you know what it is? Is because I've got a viewership of gamers. True gamers. Not viewers. Not cringe spectators. Real-ass gamers in the room. I have half Wickeds and half Copiums. Okay. Okay, let's do it. You ready? I want to intro this correctly because I told people that if I, I told people that if we got enough comments and good feedback and likes and everything on the first video, I would make another one. So that's what we're doing. So let me,
fellas.
Yeah, let me bring this up. Probably a better screenshot to get this. Alright. Probably like this. Alright. Alright, let's do it. Don't act up on the fellas. It makes me all self-conscious. I gotta get started. I don't like it. I gotta get started with my jaw. Okay, here we go. Fellas, I told you that when we did... No, I shouldn't start like that, because that doesn't make sense, because that's just predicating it on the last one. Okay. Fellas, a few weeks ago, we went over some really bad Kickstarters, and I said, if you guys liked that video, then we would do another one. And it turns out, you guys liked it. Don't laugh, this is a lot for me. This is a big number for me. Don't laugh at me. I'm getting bigger every day. Be nice. And because of that, we're going to do it again. I got some more bad Kickstarters. Let's take a look. Shall we? That's my new thing. That's my... I just decided. I'm going to do that. I'm going to go, shall we? Like that. That's good, right? You like that? We need something back. We need a way for you guys to respond back, I think. Yes. Okay. That's good. I like the yes. Okay. All right, we're going to look at some more Kickstarters. I really liked this last time. It was a lot of fun. So let's do it again. Now, I don't think I have enough... I don't think I have enough Mario sound font, so we're going back to this one. The old one. Need the Shy Guy to come down and give you a paper? I know. I don't know how to build that. I need to buy a Fly Guy, like a Fly Guy plushie, and I need to have like a string that I could cut, and he does that. You know what I mean? There's got to be a way to do that. All right, let's take a look at some Kickstarters. I think we saw the fidget spinner power bank, right? This is the one that charges as you spin it, right? That's kind of cool, actually. I like that. Yeah, I still think that's a good idea. Although, I thought all of these were good ideas. Boo the Ghost. You know the old urban legend about razor blades in the sweets? Here's a fix for something that... Oh, my God. Wait, did that never happen? Is that not real? Razor blades in the apples and stuff? Oh, God. That always makes me sad when I think about it. Maybe don't make this the first one. All right, editor? Maybe this is Twitch only.
Hi, Boo the Ghost. My name is Sam.
Damn, he needed $37,000 for a plastic bucket with a metal detector in it? Jeez, Sam.
We've all heard the horror stories.
Okay, it's not funny, okay? I'm not laughing at the things. I'm laughing at him saying that and then immediately cutting.
Boo the Ghost Inc. Okay. will stand by no further.
Not a psychopath.
We've developed and patented a proprietary detection system that picks up on these dangerous contaminants and alerts the user before any harm becomes them.
Good.
His name is Boo the Ghost.
Very cute, yeah.
We began this project with one goal in mind, to develop a child safety device that will protect kids during Halloween and restore peace of mind to parents.
Where is he? Like, I know it's, like, just a big white studio, but, like, couldn't we have gotten, like, we could have decorated a little bit. Maybe some, like, I don't know, some spider webs or cobwebs or something, or a big zombie, like a hand, or, I don't
we'll
know.
We'll take it from
Let's
here.
Let's make it a little Halloween-y.
Boo is crafted with a fully integrated, patented detection system. This system consists of a detection coil in the rim that picks up on any metallic objects and uses a vibrating handle with a built-in LED light to alert your child when they are in potential danger.
Okay, so it tells you the moment it gets dropped in? Because that's different. If that shit tells you right away, somebody drops that candy in, and you're holding up the trick-or-treat bag, and it goes, brrr, that's an awkward conversation. Can you imagine standing there in front of the house and you're just... What did you just give my son? Oh, AirPods. Oh, thank you. That's so generous. Now that's a treat. You'd actually just be killed right there. Yeah, actually, that guy would just kill you. Actually, come to think of it, yeah. If they're violent enough to do... Well, no, I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe a 50% chance, though.
Boo does this by communicating the detection through a circuit board on the interior base that triggers a multi-stage discrete alert system so that your child knows when there is a hazardous object present and that a thorough inspection of the candy should be conducted to eliminate the hazardous pin, needle, razor, or metal debris.
It's discreet, so it doesn't... Boop, boop, alert, alert, metal detected, alert the police. Calls 911 right there.
Check it out.
No, stop! Don't do that! No! Oh my God.
This is...
That was not discreet. That was very loud. That was a terrible sound to make. Imagine being the weirdo that put the razor in the candy and then you put it in...
Check it out.
Oh, did it vibrate? Yeah, it's because it vibrated on a table. Okay, but that's worse because that feels like a very strong vibration, right? Like, doesn't that feel... That's like the electric shockers they have at carnivals. You're going to drop that shit. Ow! Dude, I don't know about that.
This is the alpha prototype for Boo the Ghost. Right now, it picks up on all metal objects that pass through the rim of the container. As you can see, when a detection is made... The handle vibrates,
okay.
Making your child aware of the danger. Here at Boo the Ghost Inc., our number one priority is your child's safety.
Honestly, their number two priority should be getting a bigger bucket, because this shit's tiny. I'd eat that candy in, like, two nights. I need more, bro. Get a pillowcase.
That's why we need your help.
That's barely bigger than his head, dude.
With a sufficient backer
base... You're gonna go to the rich people neighborhood and get full Reese's bars. You ever get that? Oh my God. You ever bike over to the rich people's neighborhood and get full candy bars? Good Lord.
We'll be able to take Boo out of alpha prototyping.
You guys ever hit the jackpot and you hit... It's a full candy bar thing. It's full candy bars, but they're not home and they just left it out? Oh, baby. You've never done that? Oh my God. It's rare. I robbed them in that case? Oh, fuck yeah. Yes, absolutely. Oh, do you mean their house or the candy? I do not condone trespassing and going into an empty home, but I do condone, you know, maybe taking a couple more bars than you might otherwise. You know what I'm saying? Like, one time a house gave us ramen packets. Do not laugh at those people. They are struggling, I think. Is that cheaper or more expensive? I don't know, actually. I guess that's more expensive, right? Yeah. Four for a dollar? So that's 25 cents a pack. No, that's a lot. Yeah, because candy is like, you give like a Snickers, like a fun size, whatever.
And into mass production.
Yeah.
And you'll have the first generation of special edition Boo the Ghost child safety buckets.
Hooray!
As a backer, you'll have a front row seat to this passion project as we streamline it through the finishing stages of electrical engineering in order to get it ready for mass production and distribution.
That seems easy.
Each backer will receive a custom thank you and special recognition on our acknowledgments page.
What if that shit don't stop vibrating, though?
It's an instrumental player in bringing this essential child safety device into reality. And help
what
kids
if it's raining?
Have a safe and happy Halloween. Each and every one of you will become an integral part of our family and have
all
a unique role in restoring peace of mind for parents this upcoming trick-or-treat season.
Wait a minute. Last updated March 8th, 2023.
Don't miss out and get your copy of Boo the Ghost today while quantities last. Available for a limited time only. Don't miss it. Click the link below.
I missed it.
And check us out at BooTheGhost.ca. Join our community of backers at Kickstarter.com. And don't forget to like and share for progress milestones, feature updates, and new deals.
Join the Boo the Ghost community. The Boo the Ghost fandom is dying. This began as a passion project. Every little bit counts. $40. Boo the Ghost first edition VIP club. Ooh. Yeah. Okay. Wait, this began as a passing when an incident like this happened close to home, a young girl enjoying Halloween. Okay, so you guys were saying none of this is real. Are you sure? This never happened? I mean, it never happened. Click here for... Should I click that? Is this an ad? Oh, it's Boo the Ghost. Okay. I was going to say, what if that was an ad in the middle of the page that took me somewhere that would get me banned? All right, what's the... Any updates? What happened? Doing some retooling, lowering our per-unit costs, loyal backers, back in under a month with a new campaign. Damn! They really have to respond to the five people that gave an average of $44 each? Do they have to respond to all of them, despite not hitting their goal? Why don't they close it? Huh? One person literally asked? Well, two people. Well, no, okay. This person just said, does it work? That's not a bad idea, I guess. I mean, maybe it's not a real problem that happened, but what if it was, right? What if that was a real issue, and then this solves it in the future, right? We're future-proofing a little bit. That'd be nice. Do you work for Coney? Guys, this guy's still the number one gifter. I don't know if anybody's noticed that. I don't know if it's been discussed enough. I don't know if you guys have seen that the number one gifter spot is up for grabs, and they've only gifted one. So, you know, just wanted to bring that to everybody's attention. It's there and up for grabs for anybody that might want it. It would only I couldn't gift subs for some reason. Sorry. Could you try again? Maybe try one more time. Maybe try one more. Give it one more shot. Come on. Definitely a burner. That's the secret that I have on my other monitor. Yeah, that's what I was telling you. Yeah, that was what I was telling you about. Honestly, I think it's an L for Boo the Ghost. Damn, this one's recent. I eat all my kids' Halloween sweets. I hate that word. So they wouldn't get any foreign. Thank you, Honky Tone. Damn, with the three. This dude's rich. So they wouldn't get any foreign objects anyway. Yeah, I ate most of Juliet's candy. Her stomach isn't big enough to actually handle an L. Yo, it worked this time! Thanks, Bert, for the 10 gifties. There we go. It worked! Yeah! You just have to check more than once. But hey, maybe I'd feel bad if you did it. I was gonna say maybe check one more time. Maybe it didn't go through. If I thank you. Okay. Yeah, Juliet, she's tiny, so she can't eat all the candy, which means it's for me. How about some potato salad? I'm making potato salad. 6-9-11 backers pledged $55,000 to bring this project to life. Bring it to life? For $55,000? What did they... Basically, I'm just making potato salad. I haven't decided what kind of... They don't even know what they're going to do with the product? They don't even have a clear vision. And they got that much. An inspirational story.
A paradox when we design. To make the cutting edge familiar. And the familiar... cutting edge.
All right, I haven't seen any dates on this. When did Kickstarter come out? I'm not looking. Kickstarter launch date? 2009. This feels very 2015 humor to me. I'm going to guess 2015. This is very like 2015, like kind of like those GoFundMes that's just like, I just want to shit on my ass and drink beer and make a GoFundMe for that. So, when did this come out? 2015, 20, updated 2016. When did it start? 2014. Oh, so it was 2014. Okay. Yeah. See, there you go. there was this era when everybody was playing with these new platforms and just trying to make this kind of show, although this is very well produced. This is probably a... Never mind, only a 420. I was going to say, is this like a marketing stunt or something? I was close, you know. December 2014, basically 2015? No, because if the estimated delivery is 2014, it probably was like June 2014. So, L for me. Better mayonnaise, call a chef to get a better recipe. We made the news. Did they keep the money? How does this work? Is the pizza party going to have potato salad? No, it's just a pizza party. What type of potato salad? I don't know. It's my first one. What kind of... Do they keep it? Why wouldn't they? Because... damn, he turned this into a whole event. Something about this feels wrong. The backers are getting what they paid for. Pictures, I guess? I'm shocked he delivered like this. My ass would have been just taking a picture of some store-bought potato salad with my phone. Ta-da! Everything went great. Thanks, everybody, for the $55,000. It sucks you can't do this now. First person to do this makes $55,000. Second person to do this gets laughed at. He asked for 10 bucks. Wait, did he? Is that the... how do you know? I didn't know he asked for $10. Wow. That's incredible. He can make 5,549 portions.
Before you get any ideas, Mr. Streamer, these guys are why Kickstarter requires a prototype.
Wait, is that real? Kickstarter needs a prototype? So you need a prototype of the potato salad? Like, he would have had to make some really bad potato salad and say, guys... I need your help. And then you buy the cookbook. That's what that is. Just have the potato. It's a potato type. Kind of mixed up words there, but that's how genius happens. Look at that. Got to use GoFundMe for this kind of thing now. Yeah. What's the other one? There's GoFundMe and there's... God, there's one more. That, like, really kicked off. Indiegogo. That's it. It's a dumb name. This is silly. You get a t-shirt. This is so Reddit. This feels so Reddit to me. This was absolutely front page. This was, like, Reddit before Reddit. Oh, here we go. Funding period. Yeah. So, I was way off. Look. See? Down here. Mid of 2014. I said 2014. No, did I say 2014? Did I say 2014 or 15? I said 15. L on me. Yeah. I would have had this idea in 2015, and I would have already lost the money. Because he would have made it by then. That's dumb. Introducing... Mocase, a phone case that makes coffee? That's not bad. Wait, is it just like a thermos? Does it hold coffee? If it holds coffee, that's... Why would you... No, you don't want your phone to be hot. Your phone would overheat. I don't know if that's good.
Love comes along and you sing.
I'm withholding judgment. Let me see the product. Okay.
Love comes around and you finally found an excuse.
Very professionally made.
Love hunts you down till you're pinned to the ground. It's no use. Love comes along, turning right into wrong, so deceiving.
Show me the product, please.
Love turns the old into new.
This is why they didn't hit their funding. I haven't seen the product. I've been here for 30 seconds.
Love comes along.
If I was Kevin O'Leary, I would throw them out of the room.
That's a wrap.
Finally, a way to keep scalding liquid near my cock and balls. Yeah, I was just pouring that shit in my pocket, but this is way better.
Be enchanted by those big doughy eyes, so inviting.
I'm sorry, but I don't really have time.
Don't you have time for a coffee?
Ain't it exciting? Love comes along and
it's an app? Wait, hold on. I didn't consider it's software. Do not drink that. If a handsome, bumbling Italian man walks up to you on the street and says, would you like some coffee? And then pours it out of his phone, do not do that. Do not. Is he French? He's French. Even worse. The coffee is loading. Oh, no, I would not. Absolutely not. This is so dangerous.
He's gone.
I hope she has a phone that can detect liquid and make sure that it is untampered with. She dips her phone in the coffee. Aha, it's blue. You're going to jail.
In a
her boo ghost. Hey, put the coffee in here, buddy.
Okay, your mobile. Makes even coffee now. The original. The Italian one.
Wait, where? He is Italian, by the way. I fucking told you. Not French. Italian. Where did they get a cup?
Heartache is gone in a glimmer.
Huh. The best thing about this shot is that there's definitely just somebody else off camera just dumping like a thermos behind the phone. It's just somebody with like a Starbucks cup right here. Show me where it's coming out, bro. Come on. Come on, big brother. Show me where is that coming out of, big man? What's going on there?
Mocase, your mobile. Makes even coffee now. The original. The Italian one.
Mocase, an extraordinary cover.
She's doing business back there, bro.
Designed by a totally made in Italy team of engineers, designers.
Okay, these two extremely handsome young men, along with their coworker, an attractive young woman, they made this?
Designed by a totally.
This co-investitor?
In Italy team of engineers, designers, and...
Is everybody in Italy gorgeous?
Developers.
Everybody's beautiful.
On the latest technologies...
What the fuck?
Same time, on the relevance of the traditions of their country. The resistor is...
What
special
the fuck?
Alloy.
Resistor and a special alloy. Low consume of energies, no alteration on the normal mode of operation.
With a low consume energies.
Uh-huh.
The rechargeable lithium-ion battery of new technology that weighs less and lasts longer.
And okay, how does it make the coffee? I see that it says it warms it. Is it just a thermos you put on your phone?
energy that weighs less and lasts longer.
And so you have to dump the coffee. You have to leave your house and dump the coffee into your phone for later.
Power of the control card with integrated USB make Mokay's an incredibly original hub.
Free download on the app. I'm sold.
Thanks to the special material of all the pieces of the cover.
It's 25 milliliters. See, I don't know how much that is. I don't know. I don't know. It's nothing. Wait, a little sip. It's like 5 drops. Oh, okay. A fourth of a cup. How much is 25 milliliters? 0.006 of a gallon. Can you show me like a picture? That's 5 milliliters. That's not bad. Well, no, it's like a shot, right? Is that a shot? That looks like a shot, actually. Hmm. 30 milliliters is an ounce. What? Less than an ounce of coffee? Dude, you need a... That's if you need a shot now. Just...
The safety and comfort.
Okay, that's crazy.
I guarantee. Disposable vacuum-packed pod with liquid.
At least they're honest, though.
And simple hub.
Who needs coffee this much?
Mokay is addicted.
Even if this is real.
The good coffee was never so easy before.
You can't.
Mokay's an high-tech Italian taste.
How do you? Okay, how is the coffee Italian? The coffee is in Italian. The case is Italian, right? You have to pour in the coffee yourself. This is bizarre. Funding suspended. Kickstarter actually blocked that shit like a shot. Get that shit out of here. It fucking blocked it. Get that shit out of here. Stupid idea. That's really funny. Oh, no, it's all in Italian. How do I translate? Isn't there a way to do it? Oh, never mind. iPhone 7. Oh, here we go. This is a patent. Yep. There it is. The Mo case. It's just a phone case. Nothing different. Seems legit. Yo, Crofts, you ever need coffee really bad and you need 25 milliliters at that exact moment? Ever find a pretty girl on the street and say, hey, you want some coffee? And then pour some? Holy shit! By the way, shout out to Crofts. Dude, I saw that Daigo video. I'm going to watch that, I think, on Sunday on stream. If you guys haven't seen that, he is a sick video. I guess. I haven't watched it, but I assume it's good. Is a gamer product, sip it between games in the tournament set? Dude, does it? They say it makes coffee. I don't know. The Italian way. It's all technical Street Fighter stuff. I don't know if it's good for stream. I'll make an exception because my ass needs to learn Street Fighter 6. I don't care. I'm watching that shit. Even if I'm not riffing, my ass is learning. My ass needs to learn. I'm going to get fucked up in that game. Going for super gold. Your mobile phone cover even makes coffee suspended. Oh, they needed 82K for that, huh? I mean, that one makes sense, though. That one does actually make a lot of sense. Because, like, that does seem like an endeavor, right? Keurig for your phone. Let me put you on hold. Long sip. Risks. There are no particular risks because we developed a business plan confirming its feasibility. Oh, we're good. No problem. There's no problems at all. No, the coffee getting tampered with by all the electrical circuitry and all that shit. No, that couldn't happen. It's fine. Just drink it. The issue of cleaning the actual compartment? I did put soap in it. Who cares? Also, they're going to work really hard. So, you know, not a big deal. Learn about accountability. Okay, this rules. This is fantastic. This is my favorite one so far, I think. I love the Italian Coffee Project. If a stranger comes up to you at the bus stop and asks you to drink some liquid they produce out of their phone case. Okay, we were not alone in our cynicism. I thought it was just us. Maybe I'm a little world weary, but no, I think that's actually an issue too. I'm glad it's not just us. Very unwise to do. Also unwise to watch ads. Guys, I got no snoozies left. If you don't want ads, subscribe now. It's free with Twitch Prime. I'm warning you, you don't have a lot of time. Drop a Twitch Prime right now or a tier one. It's only $5. See you soon. You're going to the ad dimension. Take them. I need a butler. I need like a little butler to take people to the ad dimension. Maybe like a guard, a henchman, like an Igor. Take them away. Like the guy in that CDI Zelda game. This is truly one of the dumbest things I've seen in a very long time. Market growth reports, coffee and mobile phone accessories. I've got an idea that will blow the fucking lid off of the industry. Dude, oh, there's got to be a way. That sounds like a fun stream idea. Looking at market growth reports for the past year and coming up with a product to tie them together. Just looking at the biggest products of the year and the verticals and saying, what could we do to merge... Get synergy, get synergistic in this bitch. You know what I'm saying? Chat projects, yeah. I've had an idea for a while, a series that would be chat doing... maybe I'll do that. That'd be fun. I'll tell you guys about it later. I've had an idea for a series I want to do. And Lord knows I need a new series. It's been a while. I got something soon. I'll pick it up. Name it Shark Tank? No. No, it's not that. Okay. That was a good one. That might be my favorite so far. Thank you, Rock. I hope I said that right. Rock with a W. Uh-oh. It's time for a $64 spoon for parents and children. Perfect for baby's health. Make feeding fun again. When did this... 2017. It was truly miserable. This period of the time, the make X Y again, I hated that shit. This one wasn't canceled when you reviewed it last time. Wait, really? Wait, so this got canceled recently. May 9th? What happened? Project is canceled. Yep. It sure is. 27 days ago, you purchased additional parts that are easy to install. This is Penergy. Oh, they saw your video? Ah, they shut that shit down instantly, bro. They're like, oh no, we got too much heat. Too much flack. We came here from Cody. Cody said, take this down now. We hate Penergy. Damn, what an update. If you're watching this in the second video, hey, we did it. Good job, everybody. Give yourselves a round of applause. We got the pull. We got those Washington fat cats back out of Kickstarter. I don't know what I'm saying. I thought this product looked cool. Was this the one with the triangle? The power triangle? Yeah? Oh, they got picked up by Mark Cuban. Oh, he's a smart guy. Yeah, Mark probably finished this out quickly. You know, it really takes a lot of the joy out of watching Shark Tank when you realize that Mark Cuban is absurdly richer than literally everybody else in that room. Do you guys hate that? Whenever I watch Shark Tank, I'm like, that motherfucker could just buy and sell all of them five times over. He could just take deals just to fuck with them, right? He could just be an asshole if he wanted. Anyway, this is the Spoonie.
Bonjour, je me présente, je m'appelle Jacques et aujourd'hui...
Oh no, a European.
Aujourd'hui, je vais vous présenter Spoonie. Alors Spoonie, c'est la première cuillère refroidissante pour bébé. Elle vous permettra de refroidir la nourriture en un tour de main.
Ok. What the fuck? Yeah? That shit looks space age. That looks like a weapon in Fallout 4. It looks like an airplane. Well, vaguely. Looks like JJ, like a JJ the jet plane character. Is it a plane? Oh my god, it is. Never mind. I didn't see it from the front. My bad, Chatter. You were right. That's on me. It is a plane. It's kind of fucking with me. I got that mild trypophobia. Because that one image that was all over the internet back when I was a kid. You guys know that one? With the bugs? I talk about this on stream, but you guys don't know the one? The foot? No. The breast. Lotus pod. That's the one. Yep. Don't put this in the video, please. I don't want to get demonetized. Pretty bad, yeah. You mentioned it, but I haven't been able to find it. Literally look up bug nipple. Did that work? No, don't look that up. Oh my god. I shouldn't have said that. Oh my god. Okay. I'm sorry. I mean this genuinely. I don't mean this with any irony at all. I am genuinely sorry for doing that and for saying that. I'm not kidding. I feel actually bad for doing that. I this sounds like a joke, but it's not. I do have responsibility as somebody with an audience. I'm sorry. No, there's a really old image on the internet of it's a woman with it's a photoshopped image, but it looks like bugs infested her body, and it's not real. But yeah, that's the old. This is a sponsored stream. I shouldn't be doing that. Okay. Anyway, this is the Spoonie. Yep, there it is. Here comes the airplane.
Cette idée m'est venue après trois observations pour la refroidir
so
avant
instead
de la
of,
donner
instead of blowing on the spoon, the spoon blows on itself. Yeah, because when you blow on it, there's lots of bacteria. You see all these bugs? Ew!
Les parents, les amis, nous, le repas
okay, I don't...
Se passe bien.
Takes too much time, yeah. Babies take way too much time, bro. True. Grow up. Use la puissance de ventilation. Augmenter la diminuée.
Consistance de la nourriture. Qu'elle soit liquide ou
that's
solide,
the one.
Que ce soit de la
can I get the turbocharged one? So you're just blowing obscenely hot scalding soup in your baby's face?
Ou de la soupe. J'ai qui va dire que vous n'aurez pas besoin de.
Alright, you charge it. Yep.
Easily
charged. Oh my god, look at that! A bear, a plane, and a cat. Don't know why we needed a bear and a cat. I think one of the two is fine.
Avec des embouts interchangeables et la chat ou un panda.
Yeah, you put it on and then. Yeah, alright. Heat up the guacamole. The baby likes the guacamole. Or the pea. I guess it's just baby. Piece of baby food. Yup, here comes the airplane. Wow. The baby loves it. Machine washable, too. Honestly, not a terrible product. Not a bad product, I don't... Well, okay. Who would buy this? I don't know who would purchase this. But, if you were in the market for such a thing, right? Just saying. Merci. I can't read. Oh, the fan cools the food. Make feeding fun again. Good for your baby's health. Yeah. I get. How much is it, though? Like, if it's like $10, it's a fun gimmick. $55? Eat shit. I'm glad you got suspended. Or didn't finish. Or, yeah, I'm glad you're unsuccessful. Damn, 18 people with that? Hold on. 2688 divided by 18. That is an average of 150 a person? That's laundering. But not for only 2700. That's cake. That's small potatoes. No way they laundered $2,700. Unless they started like 8 Kickstarters. They had to start mad Kickstarters to get those numbers, bro. Huh? Probably family members, yeah. Dude. I guess that's why it costs 120K. Yeah, look at the spoon on the inside. She is beautiful, but she is very complex, no? You put the wine in the spoonie. Here comes the airplane. that's funny. They do like wine. What the fuck is this? Don't like that. Bro did not think we were going to read this far. The lowercase I first is spelled wrong. Come on, dude. Oh, he's French. I shouldn't say that. He doesn't understand if he's writing English bad. I feel bad now. That's my fault. You know, I could see this being a fun gag gift if it wasn't $150. Not too bad. Just don't... just use your mouth. I don't understand why the germs are such a big deal. The baby's from you, right? Like, yeah, you might give it germs, but, like, they're your germs, and it's from your body. So it's gonna get some germs anyway. Right? Not always. What, are we talking about surrogates now? Okay, if you're a surrogate, maybe don't get... Maybe you should get the spoonie. How about that? Fine. Now... A bottle opener that connects to your smartphone and automatically posts to Facebook when you open a bottle? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait. Are you ready for your first beer? Box the smart bottle opener. I actually see a use for this, and it's very sad. And I'm not kidding.
Today we are.
I see a use for this, but it's very sad. Yeah, alcoholic detected. Yep, yep. He's off the wagon again. Cry for help. Yeah. Okay. You can. If you ever open up another bottle, everybody will know, and you will be shamed, and you're gonna get. This is an ankle monitor. Yeah, basically. It's yeah. It's very sad. Bottle opener. By the way, this is very loud at this volume. How high do you think this goes?
We are launching a new.
You guys want to turn it up? All right, watch the vo- I'm turning it up all the way. Turn down your volume, okay? It's all the way up. I'm warning you. Thank you, House of Zulu. Real quick, okay? If you're muting, I'll do this when we're unmuted, okay? Or when we're done, okay? Here we go.
New way of thinking what a bottle opener can do. Introducing Bottle Opener X, the world's first smart bottle opener.
God damn! Okay, we're done. unmute. Okay. Holy shit. Somebody just got fired from their job. They probably couldn't get to the phone fast enough to turn it off. I just paid off that car, and now it's in the river. Flew off the fucking bridge. I'm on 1% and my headphones were vibrating. I don't know why that happened. Is it good now?
Each okay. Box is hand.
As a recovering alcoholic, I admit we would never buy one of these things. We're drunks, but not total morons. I mean, like, somebody would give it to you, but you wouldn't use
crafted
it, right?
With the finest materials, solid wood and stainless steel.
By the way, unironically, congratulations. Good luck with your... I know that's very hard to do, so getting genuine here. Congratulations. I mean that.
We made great effort in designing Box so you can hold it comfortably.
I love stock footage. I love stock footage of people doing work. Finest material, solid wood. I mean, what's pretty... What's that? Well, that shit will rot, I guess.
Silicon curves. Box is beautiful to look at as it is to use.
It is pretty.
Using only one hand, slide Box on top of the cap. Grab the neck of the bottle firmly. Pop the cap. Release and enjoy your bottle.
Damn, that is kind of cool, though.
Box is fit.
That shit has a battery in it? What?
Box is fitted with a smart chip to connect with your phone through Wi-Fi. Its innovative feature will seamlessly share that moment with your friends. Just select your group of friends from your favorite chat platform.
Oh my god. Somebody probably got this and it bugged out and it's sent to everybody on their messenger list. He's drinking again. Dude, it's gonna send a notification every time you do it. You're 8 beers in and somebody's like, hey, somebody's gotta go check up on Greg. Hey, Greg is like 12 millers deep. What? We gotta check him out. Imagine seeing someone's page and it's their last 10 messages. Yeah, exactly. Like, hey, are you guys okay? Something's going on with Tommy. We gotta figure this out. Imagine having a party with that.
You turning this up caused my subwoofers to trigger.
Bro, it's not my fault. It's the ad. The ad was loud. Dude, a party and just everybody's popping bottles and it just... notifications going crazy.
And the next time you open a bottle, Box will automatically share with them a special cheers message wherever they are. As the saying goes, it's five...
Oh my god. Wait, they count how many? They don't do it individually. They, like, compile them together. So if you got, like, 10 of them, it would, like, be 10 beers at home. Oh, Jesus. Mark, you all right?
5 p.m. somewhere on Earth for beer.
Pop that shit open. Your alcoholic friend who's trying really hard to stay on the narrow path is just depressed, just staring at it.
Your fun times are limited.
She took the kids. Just opened 10 bottles at home.
Just let Box open your new experience.
Wait, was this at the doctor's? What the fuck is this? What is this guy doing? This guy is a problem. Why is he doing that there? Oh, because his arm is in a sling. He can only use one hand. Doctor prescribed. You need a couple brewskis, stat. Yeah.
Just let Box open your new experience.
Okay, I don't. I think these might be photoshopped now that we're seeing more of them.
Join us. Get your Box. Enjoy your bottle. Live the real moment. And let Box do the sharing your way.
This feels AI generated. Which is weird because it's from 2016. Did they have it?
Box. The smart bottle opener.
Need myself a sex beer? All right, I hear shower beer. I don't drink, but I hear shower beers go crazy. Never had a sex beer or heard anybody talk about it. But that does sound a little nuts. Hear that's a little crazy. Shower beer sounds sad? Apparently it's fantastic. Orange shower over a beer shower. Orange shower? Like... orange juice? Shower orange. Wait, like the fruit? Wait, you're eating the fruit? I'm getting you one for your birthday since I know you love to pop a cold one while in the toilet. Yep, that's me. You know, I like to pop one of those open when I have my alone time. Yep. A sex beer would require insane multitasking. Depends. Never mind. I'm not going down this route. Bit. Undo. Not doing that bit. What's CHF? Swiss francs? Is that saying that right? Am I being too francs? Francs? Francs like the hot dog or francs like the francs? Yeah. Damn, this got funded, huh? The Verge, New York, like the city, New York Mag, Digital Trends, Curbed, Popular Mechanics, Yahoo, MSN, SBTV. Damn, dude. I mean, maybe. I don't drink. You guys, are these like, would you guys be into this? I don't see a use case, really, but. Yeah, that's a lot of comments. Sorry to be asking questions so late. I never got my product. Are you still selling it? We've been working out all the key issues as 5 years ago. Mine stopped working. Little buttons is clicked. Oh, yeah. It's like flimsy little stuff, right? You could probably get this now on like Amazon. I bet they made one. You could absolutely just make this shit, right? Just steal that. 3D print this? Yeah, dude. Five Below has these. Yeah, this feels like a Five Below product. This feels easy now. The one-handed opener is neat. I don't know why it has to be connected. Let me peep the Reddit. Way to let all your friends know you have a drinking problem without actually having to say it. See, that was the angle I saw. That was what I thought of. Just text her, bro, the bottle opener. Dude, actually, that's not a bad icebreaker, right? Because, like, if you're I haven't dated in a while. But, like, let me know. Am I crazy for this? Like, you're friends with somebody, and then you're, like, talking back and forth, and then you pop one at home, and it tells her, and you're like, oh, sorry, that was my thing. And she's like, what's that? And you tell her about it. She's like, oh, that's kind of stupid. And maybe she'll just stop being interested in you because you bought this stupid fucking product. But maybe it's like, oh, that's cool. What did you get? And then you talk back and forth, right? Maybe. I feel like that could be a good icebreaker. You don't think so? There's a chance. That's what I like to hear. Yup. It could work. Riz game level 0. I haven't had to work on it in a while. I've been with my wife for a long time. All right. I got to get back up to speed. Welcome to the Cyber Matrix 100. Gaming of the future. Made 190. Damn, what was the 25K? This probably goes crazy, whatever this is. What's the Cyber Matrix? Oh, loading up. That's Nemo. I live in St. Louis for about 18 years now, raised in a poor household, always spend money on things I only want rather need, in a house of just my parents and me. However, I was raised in Orlando in a house of two older sisters and one older brother. I was raised in a large-sized family, but I live alone with parents that, all right, yeah, all right. The Cyber Matrix has the ability to make video and cyber-based games using one engine, and you can make movies and music as well with one engine. It comes with the power booth, power portal, cyber stove, ROM attachment, galaxy attachment, artificial intelligence system, AI system, and remember, this was like in 2019, so, you know, he probably had a jump on it, and a power controller. Look at all that. I get all that? For how much? Oh, it even has the controller, dude. What's this button do? I'm not hitting that shit. I get all these buttons. What is this little? It looks like a mole. Why the controller got a beauty mark? I don't like that. What is this back here? The controller has a skin graft. What the fuck is that? Heat pad for only your right hand? Is that what that is? Ah, yeah, okay. The CM. Yep. Okay. Game title here. Yes. Cyber Matrix. Now load. Is this the game? I can't. Am I in the game? Welcome to the future of video gaming. The central start of. I'm not. There's that cyber stove again. There it is. Please select the certification level. Please note you cannot be administrator until the creator has set up their account as creator. What the fuck am I looking at? The reason for the relaunch is because it didn't succeed. This time I increased my project over 2,500 to 25K. The reason for that is because my pre-project failed. So his early Cyber Matrix project failed for 2,500. And he said, oh yeah? And then he bumped it up. By, what, 1,000%? Is that what that is? Can you do that? Risks and challenges. Having to patent it. I feel like communicating the idea is kind of risky. I don't know what the... he's not wrong. What's the... Okay. Remember, all parts of the... Oh, all the comments are him. Wait. Dude, why do you ask for so much? Oh, this guy is into cyber culture. this guy has fucking I have no mouth and I must scream as his avatar. He is waiting for the AI. This guy wants this for some nefarious purposes. If you wanted $500, I bet you get it in no time. In a serious note, I do have a question about the Cyber Matrix. Oh, me too. I have plenty. As a person that's in a wheelchair, I would like... Oh, that's sad. I would like to know if that would be the same once I enter the cyber world. I don't mind going on some adventures or participating in the battlefield, but I would prefer it if I could take my chair too. It might seem odd, but it's part of my identity. It makes me feel unique, and it's just who I am. Will I be able to make an avatar that is accurate to my real self, or will I have to be another lame walker in the war game? No answer. Is owning a Cyber Matrix 100 going to be seen as an act of terror? Uh-huh. If anyone has any question, any answers on how to... Oh, it... Okay. So I think my brain kind of filled in the blanks as I was reading that sentence. I thought it was going to say, if anybody has any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. But no, if anyone has any answers on how to make it... this is a young Elon Musk, you know? He's got a lot of ideas. All he needs is somebody to help him build it. And a lot of money. He's an emerald mine to help him out. Look at these diagram images. Yup. He's a kid with too much time. Welcome to the gaming of tomorrow. We will be able to make and play games. Wait, cybermatrix.com? Fuck. Oh, never mind. He made it. Now he does event scheduling and time tracking software. Good job, kid. He did it big. What if it showed my IP somewhere on this page in like really small letters and I didn't notice until now? Oh, dear. Good job, Sean, with a CH. What the fuck is that? I've never seen that before. Sean? Huh? What is that for? Schwan. That's weird. I knew a guy named Sean, but it was spelled Tion. Tion? Tion? Like that? Tion? That's crazy. Go back to the questions. He asked if he could make a console out of Lego? Wait, what? For those who are concerned about my console being used as an act of terror, it won't. Oh, phew, thank God. For those of you who are physically disabled, why didn't he just reply? People, everybody, stop clamoring. Many people have been asking if my console it can be used as an act of terror. Once you enter cyberspace, your avatar will apply to your life form. Okay, where's the Lego? I didn't notice this. I need tips on how to make it. Do I need soldering tools? Can I use hot glue or even Lego? Maybe. I don't know. No, wait, this one got funded? Wait, it was $500. Wait, that guy gave him the idea of $500. And then he was like, oh, that's a good idea. And then we hit it. Congratulations. Watch the video.
Kickstarter.
Oh, now I feel bad. I don't want to watch it. When you put a face to it, I feel bad now. I thought it was a kid. No, never mind. Now I feel... Oh, man. When you put a face to it, it's not funny anymore. Now it's sad. Oh. Risks and challenges. Nothing. All right, editor, just let's pretend we never saw this link, okay? Let's pretend we never saw that. I believe in the Cyber Matrix 100. And now you look like a dick. Yeah, that's usually how this goes. Usually the way the stream goes is we laugh and I make jokes and then I go too far and I feel bad about it. That's like 90% of the stream. Now, a USP ice machine that can make a single tiny ice cube in only 6 minutes. Or two ice cubes in 4 minutes. Let's see. Yep. Damn, that is small. All right, you plug that shit in. Plug in the ice maker. Yes, cultivate the ice. Merely 4 minutes is all it takes for a perfect cube. Just kidding, it's 7.5. It's a little bit more than that. Freeze the water for my icy frozen concoction will soon be at hand. Where's the ice cube? I haven't seen a single ice cube. I'm just looking at timers. Where's the ice? Oh, shit. There it is. Damn. That shit looked nice. 2 ice cubes in just 4 minutes. Wait, that was the ice that he was holding? That's the ice? Oh, I thought it was a little plastic piece. It's more like an ice waffle. It's so small. That shit is melting immediately. How big is that in his hand? This dude better have the biggest hands on the fucking... I better be looking at Andre the Giant here. If that's a normal average-sized man... Ice McRib. Okay, unironically, I'd be chewing on that shit. I would be chewing. I'm about to buy one and then show it off at a science fair. This shit go crazy at science competitions. Yeah, dude, I would buy this and be like, I made this. I would get the blue ribbon, first place. I get a scholarship. I made an ice cube maker. How'd you do it? I plug it in, and then it freezes. That seems bad. Well, the Pico Ice Maker, smallest of our machines, can be the smallest in the world. Yup. Ice Dynamics aimed to supply you with the best ice machines of the moment. We work on many options. How many ways can you make ice? Oh, they're not meant to do only ice machines. We have an enormous project interesting to propose on Kickstarter. So true. Hmm. Yeah, so who is this for? Future model, very interesting. Hmm. Color me, very interest. An option for an adapter for cooling a canned soda? Why didn't you just make that? Just make, that's way better and faster. Why wouldn't you just do that? Surely the video's not actually available. Oh, it is. Oh, never mind. No, ice maker box. Is it bigger? It looks the same. Okay. Futuristic look. I mean, I get, damn, that's bigger, actually. That's not bad. Is that a shot glass? I can't tell how big anything is, dude. All this shit, it keeps changing size on me. How big is any of these? They're in Switzerland. Okay. Comments. Best of luck. Look forward to the launch. Our machines are cool. We try to put it at a reasonable price. What's the price? This is so cool, but it's bloody expensive. How much? Hold on. How much are we talking? $40! Well, 40 francs. How much is 40 francs? How much is 40 francs to USD? $45! I thought it would be less! Why does that cost more? Dude? God damn, thank you, Re-Evolution, for the tier 3. I never see a tier 3. That's crazy. Jeez, $25 a month, thank you. $45 dues for one ice cube maker. Holy shit. It's a funny gift, though. What did they say? If it made like a drink's worth of ice cubes, that'd be neat. I hate putting water into that thing and waiting 2 hours for it to freeze. Yeah, I like a portable ice cube maker might be valuable. But I don't know. I don't need ice that much. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't need it that much and that often. I can walk outside and get ice for free. Where do you live? It's May. Where's ice for you? Do I have Alaska viewers? Isn't it bedtime for you? It's nighttime up there. Or daytime. I don't know. Ain't that shit like long as hell? Penguin and Jet. I'm curious. This could potentially be useful if you're stuck somewhere with power but no cooling and need ice. Not a horrible concept. I mean, I guess. Imagine that showing up on Shark Tank. Mark Cuban would buy it just to fuck with the other guys. Now, say hello to Hashkey, a dedicated one-key keyboard for the hashtag. This is so 2015, right? 2014, I should have guessed, even earlier. Again, this is that gag shit. Kickstarter had all this stupid gag shit. Oh, dude, you know what's nuts? You remember that pandemic craze when, like, inventors started making external mute buttons? Oh my god, dude. Like, they made a killing on that. You don't know what I'm talking about? Hold on. Hold on. Wait. Big mute button. I don't know how to put this. Yes. This is it. A physical mute button for Zoom. It's illuminated. This was huge, huge during the pandemic. Because boomers were on Zoom calls and they're like, they were saying some wacky shit. Never heard of it? Dude, these were big. They were all over. And people bought them. Seriously. $30. $30. A mute button that shows everyone when your mic is live. See, it's like that. Unbelievable. That's how you... That is the perfect seizing of the market. Genuinely. Some people who just knew how to plug a USB into a single button interface just mute. It all this does is activate a hotkey on your keyboard. Unbelievable. Probably made millions. Fuck. Should have thought of that. Nuts. The boomers at my shitty 9-to-5 office job were all about these useless things. Yeah, dude, they love this shit. So that's just this, but this is worse. It doesn't even... Dude, honestly, if I was a boomer and I had no idea what I was doing on Zoom calls, I might buy one too. Better that than saying something that's going to ruin your career, right? That's way scarier. You say something on Zoom that you think you're muted, talk shit about a boss, right? Ooh.
For better or for worse, the Humble hashtag has revolutionized the way we communicate with each other.
Hashtag get my cookie on. Hashtag I'm the real cookie monster. Hashtag no 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 no.
That's so weird that it was ever like a thing people did.
No no.
Delicious, right? Yeah. Hashtag I did it all for the cookie. Hashtag LOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLO
is trying as hard as he can. I don't think Jimmy's a bad guy. I think he's really trying. James Corden, I want to go to hell. I wish James Corden nothing but pain and misery. But I think Jimmy is trying to keep his head above water. Yeah. I think Jimmy found a shtick, and he's doing it until he dies because it makes him a lot of money. But inside, he feels empty. That's my read on Jimmy Fallon. And I think he's struggling as much as anyone else in this world. I don't wish any happiness for James Corden. Something about James Corden just is so off-putting to me. I don't know what it is.
Hashtag classic.
The hashtag is the third most used keyboard character, after the letter X, and the weird S-looking thing that looks like two snakes having a 69, which no one knows the name of. Lack of a dedicated hashtag key has been linked to everything from finger cramps to delirium to desperation.
Yeah, so this is a very funny gag gift. LOL.
The lost time it takes having to press Alt and 3 instead of just one key is estimated to cost...
Jimmy Fallon reminds me of the guy that hosts the Hunger Games. The guy with the blue hair and the makeup? Really? You think so? I don't think of him like that.
The global digital economy, somewhere between £32 and €20 billion a year.
Season.
So isn't it about time the hashtag had its own key? Hashtag.
Wait, that was Stanley Tucci? Oh my god, it was, wasn't it? I never really thought of that. Huh.
Tag lovers of the world, your prayers have been answered.
I like Jimmy Fallon.
Introducing Hashkey.
This is stupid.
With you wherever you go, heart's content.
This is so dumb. Thank god. There were two ways this would go. It didn't get funded or it hit like 8 million. Just take my money, kind sir. 10 updutes to you. Shut up and take my money. Right? I'm glad it didn't work. Great, fun, and clever idea.
Here we go!
Said Shed at a party.
Jimmy
when I cornered
Fallon
him.
Is cool. Did you guys see his super cool board ape?
Okay, again. I think he was forced to do this. I don't think he's happy. She looks rather proud. I think he was doing a bounty, guys. I think this is a bounty. This is a sponsored bit, I think he was doing. I think that's what that was. And the bag was immeasurable. I think that's what that was. Coney would do it if he was paid like that. I done told you guys. If a crypto sponsor came in for $10 million for a month, it would be crypto month. Crypto May on the Coney stream. And then we would never talk about it again. Absolutely. Crypto May on the Coney stream. You guys don't have to buy shit. I just have to tell you about it. That's the job. I don't need to convert anybody. I'd do the crypto dance all of May. Would you buy an NFT if your friends told you to? My friends told me not to, so I didn't, because everybody told me not to do it. And I didn't. I kind of stayed out of it because I didn't understand it. I was like, this is kind of weird. And everybody said, it's bad. I'm like, okay. All right, sure, I guess. And then it's bad. You got it. Yeah, this is stupid. I don't. This is dumb, and I hate internet culture. Bummer. Time to find another path to hashtag launch. This guy definitely runs a LinkedIn blog. Look at him. This guy posts on LinkedIn daily. Okay. It's time for... $10,000 to send your DNA to the future? What?
In the future, human cloning will be a reality.
Yeah.
Legal, regulated, safe.
Wait. You send yourself to the future and then you create a clone in the future. Dude.
A sort of human immortality will exist.
Send me to the fucking Ark!
Fortunately, it'll be too late for you.
Damn, that's kind of fucked up. 8 people are going to the Ark. You're going to be so sad when you aren't on the Ark with all of us. We're all partying on the last ship.
You'll be dead. But what if you could live...
Jeez. Why did she have to say it like that?
Unfortunately, it'll be too late for you. You'll be dead.
Yeah, I got the implication. You have to really drive it in there.
But what if...
You'll be dead too, lady. Yeah, what the fuck's your problem?
If you could live again... Come back for a second round with your soulmate, your children, your best friends, 6 members of the football team. Well, now you can.
What did she mean by that? I don't know what that meant. Does it?
Okay. And with...
Like, I'm wondering if that meant what I think it meant, but maybe I just don't understand.
It goes on DNA gene bank time capsule. All that's needed is a tiny sample of your DNA, the building blocks of life that made you. enough to grow another you and anybody with you.
This is like I feel like I could see this intro in a game like Prey 2, right? This is like an arcane game intro for the dystopian company of the future. This is like the opening to that new BioShock game.
Just collect a few hairs, some nail clippings, or a tooth or bone fragment.
Imagine being the mailman who has to deliver this. When this falls out of the packaging, you're like, what's in here? Oh, God!
And insert them into a glass vial.
Wait.
And anybody with you.
Okay.
Just collect a few hairs.
Easy.
Some nail clippings.
Very easy.
Or a tooth or bone fragment.
Where do I get those? I know... I know a couple. I don't know where I'm getting a bone or a tooth, really. I shouldn't do that. I am getting a tooth removed, I guess. My wisdom teeth.
And insert them.
I guess a tooth is a small price to pay for immortality, right? We're going to the Ark!
Into a glass
vial.
Let's
go, fellas!
Store the vials inside your capsule. As soon as you've collected all the samples you need from anybody you want to take on this journey with you, seal your capsule and deposit it anywhere. At sea.
Anywhere?
Buried in the backyard, on the mantle as a tribute to your life and the lives of those you love.
What?
Nothing is lost forever. And someday, an archaeologist, a scuba diver, a backyard explorer will find your capsule. And that unique sequence of DNA that is you will get a second chance at life.
What the fuck? Oh my God. Cut out your hair, clip off your nails, take out your tooth, and bury it in the backyard. There's... And hope. Pray that someone will know what to do with it. Pray that you get dug up in 500 years. And not two. Oh my God.
Just imagine what your future holds.
Yeah, man. Wait, so what's the product? Is it just a box? It's a ball. You just made a ball. I thought they were sending, like, an institute that you send this shit to. I thought you send it to an institute and they take care of it. No, it's just a ball. Sick, man. Dual gold medalist at 2 international inventions expos. Oh, my God. This is literally just Soma. Uh-huh. Couldn't I just buy a box? Or 3D print? Oh, not the clip art of Einstein. This dude is selling nobody. This is like anti-Riz for marketers. A clip art Einstein? What are you doing? What is this facility? That looks like the second level in Time Splitters, right? Huh? It's like the dam in GoldenEye. What the fuck am I looking at? This guy is talking. Oh, they come in different colors. Well, hold on. Wait a minute. Your DNA in space. Imagine digging up a capsule of hair and teeth. Well, I imagine there's like a note. Wait, our exclusive 1,000-year, 1,000 money-back guarantee. Wait a minute. Pretty good. I got an idea. Wouldn't it make more sense to send only the sequence of your genome? Check out this fucking dork. Check out this piece of work. Geek. I think these would make a great gift. That's a family member. That has to be. That's not a real guy. Daniel is not a real guy. Yeah, really good idea. This is literally just Soma, right? This is the plot of Soma, but on Kickstarter. Sock account. Can you do that on Kickstarter? Probably a lot of people have done that on Kickstarter, I'm sure. I just love that it's just a ball. It's just a ball that you bury wherever you want. They don't even tell you where to go. Nothing is being sent to the future. You spit in a glass vial and seal it in a rubber ball, and this means your future someone will do some vague science stuff. Fuck yeah! It's not a bad idea. I could see people buying... Okay, it is a bad idea. I could see people buying into it. Pretty good marketing. You're totally right about people in the future not giving a shit. Yeah, who's gonna, like, find that in the future and be like, I know what I should do with this. Make a new person. I should make a whole new person with this ball of teeth and hair. I'm gonna make a new human being. That's ethical. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Ads in 5 seconds. Ad jump scare. Sorry, everybody. LaFlesh, though... Look at LaFlesh. Wise. Very wise. Popping the Prime for free. Subscribing for free. And not having to see the ads. I love it. I love it when they do that. I love it. So wise. Love a wise chat. All right. Don't leak anything. Hold on. Love me a wise chatter who's always on the ball. We get ads once an hour, okay? Don't whine about it. Okay. Oh, geez, I got to do the ad stuff. We got a couple more to look at. What's this? Video game developer raises $120,000 for his game Unforgotten Quest. Was fully funded in 2012, said the game would be finished in 2 years. This game has not been released and doesn't have a release date. Well, well, well. I can't believe this is the only one like that. There's got to be a million of these, right? Oh my god. They deserved it. They absolutely deserved it. Everybody that got scammed here deserved it. You got by a Kongregate game. Okay, wait, so this is 2012? Would this even be impressive in 2012? Games that came out in 2012. The same year as Borderlands 2, Dishonored, Far Cry 3, Max Payne 3, Mass Effect 3. Damn, a lot of threes. Well, maybe. Black Ops 2, Resident Evil 6. There's a giraffe getting a blowjob. Jump scare. If you guys haven't, I saw somebody commented on that video recently, on the video that I talked about that. They're like, oh, now I can't unsee it, so it's fresh in my mind. Hey, if you were that commenter, this one's for you. That commenter, they just commented like 2 days ago. They're going to be like, oh, son of a bitch, not again. They think I'm talking directly to them. That's funny. That poor guy. But that's what it is. That's actually what that... What video was it? I don't even remember. I just remember the logo is a giraffe receiving fellatio. That's... Yeah. Family Guy came out that year? No, it didn't. 2012? No. That was way before. I remember watching it with my high school friend. Or middle school? Maybe even middle school friend. We were like... They're saying bad words. 99. Oh, Jesus. That was way long. Why did I believe that person? Unforgotten Quest. Don't. I know what you're gonna do. Don't do it. I know what you're thinking. Don't. It's so stupid. You, maybe for that. Maybe for the Valkyrie.
I have a quest for you to do.
Oh, this shit killed in this in 2012.
One involving bear first, you know, the kind with low drop rates too.
Oh, right? They loved it. Stampy, was that his name?
Enter into the mysterious forest, slay yeah. A dozen kobolds in the forgotten den.
Very silly wizard or British voices, very quirky. Stamper, that was his name.
And if you dis-
I'm not watching all 8 minutes. Well. No. This is 1 year before before Battle Block Theater. That's what I was thinking of. Yeah.
For when you reach the bottom,
You'll hear a big loud roar.
I'm done. Wow. Okay, so it's a stage builder. That guy, very bold to put your face on this. That guy probably got harassed. Hold on. This is an update. Yeah. I guess it did. Wait, this is Unforgotten Quest. Wait, is this two? Is this the same one? Yes. Okay. It failed. Video unavailable. Private. Announcing it's failed. Before I talk about it, compensation. I feel ashamed. I mean, like, this is just like... There is times that people know I don't accept Rob Surrender. The table... I'm not reading this. So there was a time where a lot of people were like, I'll just make a game. And then they realize how hard it is. Right? Like, they'll be like, I want to do that. I'm going to put an idea up on Kickstarter and make $1 million. And then it's like, oh, that shit kind of hard, actually. Oh, wait a minute. That shit not easy. Oh, my God. I just got another Men's Warehouse bounty. Lock that shit in. I'll see you guys on Sunday, maybe. Oh, hell yeah. You guys want to browse Men's Warehouse with me? We watched Low Tide City, huh? You're going to like the way you look. You better. Yeah, man. Can't wait. 8 minutes. Yeah, I feel like everybody thought they could just make a game. I thought you were going to say Low Tier God. Oh, Low Tide. Oh, I see. That is close, actually. As long as I get a jacket, hey, I'll show you a bunch of jackets and you'll pick one. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of people just wanted to make a game. They're like, I bet I could get a lot of money this way, but they had no idea. Well, this guy, I don't know. That's not even true, because there's clearly something here. It looks like dog shit, but they had a vision, right? Just how games looked, I guess. When is your game, Coney? I'm working on it. Twisted Metal Battle Royale. It's coming. One day, I'm making it. Don't worry. It's on the way. Yeah, this is just a poor product of its time, bro. At least he gave an update in February 2018. They're giving refunds. God bless. A new BR isn't going to succeed? Maybe yours won't. My BR will go crazy. 800,000 people at launch. 900,000 a month later. I got plans. All right, that was all the Kickstarters, but we got some honorable mentions. Shoutouts to Juicero, which was on, it was a $400 juicer, right? This was on Kickstarter. I remember this. You would put the juice bag in there and it would juice for you. Everybody knew about this one. Oh, never mind. Okay, it was supposed to be $200. Not as bad. Not as bad. It wasn't a juicer? Wait, it wasn't? Wait, so it was just in the bag? The product was just in the bag and it would just squeeze the bag. You were paying for a bag squeezer. That's an Apple product, bro. That feels very Apple to me. That's very Tim Cook. That's some Steve Jobs shit, bro. If we could only squeeze that specific brand of bag. Yeah, but what other bags would you squeeze? Where else would you do it? Apple, pear, orange, anything. Not even a mix. The sweet greens. Get some veggies in there, bro. And the last honorable mention. And you know it had to be on here. Who remembers Mighty Number 9 from the creator of Mega Man? From Mega Man's dad. Inafune, I think that's how you say it. He constructed Mega Man. Damn, this is convincing. It really is convincing. From the ground up, Mighty Number 9 is coming to change the industry. Mighty Number 9 will change gaming in a way never seen before. Oh no! Oh no! What happened? Mighty Number 52. I can't. Oh, the $4 million, Keith. $4 million. What did you do? Did I call him Keith? Was that his name? KG. Why did I say Keith? It was K-E-I. I think I don't know why I filled that in. Keith Inafune. Yeah, I don't know why I got that. KG, $4 million. What? They even have a PayPal page with 200K on it. KG, no. Honestly, dude, was this the first Kickstarter that, like, had, like, the super mass appeal that just bombed? My name was in the backer credits, my eternal shame. I felt so smug for not backing this game. I felt so goddamn intelligent. I knew better. I knew that wouldn't be good. Ouya 2, I thought the Ouya would be bad, too. I guessed. I was like, that shit's not going to be good. I guess it's just easier to say that. So Happy Bloodstained came out well. Not for me. I had it on Switch. You ever play that game on Switch? Oh my God. You know what the worst part is? Switch doesn't have refunds. Not like Steam. Look at this shit. Here's Bloodstained on Switch. Here's a review.
Start. Was avoiding having Dracula as your main opponent, which, to be fair, template that's this
just,
accomplished. Is there a reason to chastise someone for taking the safe route? Perhaps not in this case, but unfortunately, Nintendo Switch owners do have a few more things to grumble about when compared to their PlayStation
the
and Xbox
owning friends.
The frame rate
gets ugly.
In addition to
and the characters
basic,
just look a little
red. The
entire
castle
is gross,
the
man.
You start the game. But portions can only be accessed once
I didn't realize this was a real game. I thought people were playing a joke on me. Like, I thought people were, like, memeing. Like, LOL Bloodstained is so good. And I was like, haha, yeah, it sucks, right? But it looks good on other
That's
systems.
A certain item or ability. Save points are dotted around the building. As
oh,
our-
it's so gross. I fell for it. Didn't fall for this, though, LOL. The 3DS is still available for pre-order? Wait, what? You've got to be kidding. Hey, January 1st, 2025. Only a year and a half left, guys. Very soon. You want to get it. It's going to sell out quickly. January 1st, 2025. That, damn, this thing is big. Do you guys remember this trailer?
Let me ask you a question. Do you like awesome things that are awesome? Then you gotta play this game, dude.
I forgot.
And crazy addictive, like popping bubble wrap addictive. Check this out.
The pizza explosions. It looks
addictive,
like a pizza
like popping
pie.
Bubble wrap addictive. Check this out.
Oh, it looks like pizza. I remember that.
See, that's your dash move. There's a short dash, a long dash, jump dash, spiral, slide. There's probably a dash that makes you breakfast. I don't know.
Great idea. Wait, what?
Point is.
Dude, that was 6 years ago? That's all? It feels so much older. Oh my God. We really were in a comedy recession during this time. 7 years? Oh my God, you're right. Yeah. Comedy was in a Great Depression during this time.
You're dashing around like a friggin' moon man.
Was it something I said as dialogue?
I love it. Oh, and look at this. There's all these combo moves you can do. Then you can do combos on combos to rack up your score.
Hey, 6.3K likes, though, on 2 million views. I'll help him out a little bit. I like this. I shouldn't do that. Then I'm going to get Mighty Number 9 content. No thanks. No dislikes. Yeah. No, zero dislikes. They love it. W. This game kind of looks sick. It's not. I played it because I thought it would be funny. It wasn't. Really bad. Nope. It's not fun. I think I beat it on stream too. It's very bad. It's but hey, maybe it'll be better on the 3D. I just realized it's the 3DS. Do they still make games for that? That's just not even coming out for the Switch. You'd play it for a bounty, though, in a fucking heartbeat. Yes. Are you kidding? Right now I have Genshin. No, I have Summoner's War Chronicles, which is for an hour. I did it for 20 minutes. And a watch party for Citadel Season 1. No thanks. I would do this shit in a heartbeat. For how much? Not that much. I would play any bad game for money. Truly. Speaking of, I got an offer today to do a sponsored stream on a, it's on a YouTube stream. And I was like, I don't stream on YouTube. And they were like, okay, well, never mind. I'm like, what the fuck? Huh? Wasn't there supposed to be a Mighty No. 9 anime? Was there? there was supposed to be an ARMS graphic novel, too. But that shit is dead. Don't know why. Maybe when ARMS 2 comes out. Fellas, thanks for checking out more bad Kickstarters. I love this. Maybe we'll do it again soon. Or just check out other Reddits. I had a good time. Hey, shout-outs to the mods, Keen and E. Compton. Let's give it up. Let's give it up. Drake it up for the mods that make this possible. Thanks, Keen and E. Compton. Did you guys have a good time? I don't care. I care about you, the YouTube viewer. Comment and like below, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye. Goodbye, YouTube viewer. And only YouTube viewer. Goodbye. Subscribe, please. See, I'm being so friendly to you. It'd be a shame if you didn't subscribe because I'm being so nice. Subscribe, please. That was fun. I love these. I just like looking at subreddits curated. I want to do another drive. Not the driving one, I guess. Because I already did the car one. That's a little old now, but... Are you wearing a Kane shirt? Hell yeah. I got the hat, too. When I was in LA, they had these shirts for $10. I'm like, fuck yeah. I love me some tendies. And I was real good. You know what else I love? Factor meals. That's right, my Factor meals just came in. I've already unboxed them and they came right to my house, so I've got 8 of these delicious meals right here. Now, if you don't know about Factor, they are fresh, never frozen meals that get delivered right to your door. All you do, you get them delivered and then you just pop them right in the fridge. Check that out. What do I have here? Cavatappi with Italian pork ragu. Mmm, delicious. Wait a minute. Okay, I did put sponsored in the stream title. Okay, what about some chorizo chili? Oh, look at that there. I hope that QR code isn't for me specifically. Uh-oh, I hope I didn't just show something bad. What about, look at the nutrition facts on the bottom. You could see it right there, the calories. We've got 47 grams of total fat, but 43 grams of protein. That's a W. And Factor delivers meals right to your house. And the difference with them and other meal services is that it already comes made, so you don't even have to cook the thing. You just pop it in the microwave and have some delicious roasted garlic chicken. And they're all chef prepared, like I said before. It is delicious. There's roasted garlic chicken, cavatappi and Italian pork ragu, shredded chicken taco bowl, herb grilled chicken, braised beef ragu pasta. Mm-mm. I can't wait to eat all 8 of these delicious chef-prepared meals. And if you want to try these for yourself, listen, I've got the hookup for you. Just go to factor75.com, I think. I don't know. Go to whatever this says. And use my code FACTORSE36763. And you can get 50% off of your first box. That's right. 50% off of your first box. And I will extend that offer to everybody here right now. We don't have many of those, okay? We don't have many of those left, so I'm going to give that over to you. So go ahead and order that a box because it's 50% off. You get so many meals, and it's so much cheaper than it would normally be. It's already inexpensive, but with your first box, 50% off, you would be a dummy not to do it. It was like $60 for 8 meals. You can't get that anywhere. Delivered right to you? Mmm. So get engaged with Factor Delivery Meals. Thanks, Factor, for sponsoring this stream. Factor won't fix your balding. I'm not balding. I ask every time I get a haircut, and they always say no. They always say I'm not. Can we do Salty Bet? You want to do Salty Bet? Might do a cheeky bit of Salty Bet. I would rather I had a different plan in mind. It's not Fall Guys. 6 more matches till attorney? Mm. don't think we got time, do we? Sans fight? Ooh, that's not a bad idea. I had a different thing. Hold on, let me see. I've wanted to do it. I gotta plug this in. 1 second. Just do the six? You wanna run the six? Alright. We'll do the six fights, and then we'll see what we do after that. Alright? Iceman versus Claire Redfield. Oh, fuck yeah. No, that's the wrong overlay. All right, hold on. This one's good. All right, here we go. Let's pop it.
Before you get any ideas, Mr. What? Streamer, these guys are why Kickstarter requires a prototype now.
Oh, I was like, what? Dude, you're so late. I thought that was a super mobile viewer.
Knuckles, you turning this head up caused my subwoofers to
hold
trigger.
On, how do I reset this? I'll reload it. There we go. Why was Chicken Little there? It's a long story. it's hard to explain. Oh god, this shit is large. What the fuck? No. There we go. Alright, good luck everybody. Oh, it's too long. Good luck everybody. I'm ending submissions. Do not ask him about aliens. What a stupid fucking level. Bobby Iceman is one of the most powerful X-Men with the ability to freeze the whole Earth, too. What? Bobby Iceman? There's no way that's his name. Look at how fast he is. He's losing to Claire Redfield. Use the bazooka. Oh, my God. All right, that did a lot, actually. That did a lot of damage. Good Lord. Okay, she's too... Yeah, okay, so he's actually really strong, though, right? He just lost to a normal person. Just a non-superpowered woman. What? I can't see the... Okay. Puppaz versus Hayate Esvex? Oh, that's probably Street Fighter EX, right? Okay. Easy points? I don't know who Puppaz is. Uh-oh. Place your bets. Whenever I see a character like this, I'm like, This is kind of troubling, right? Dude, the Snake Eater music was crazy. Is this the one in Smash? What tier? I don't know. I don't pay attention to tears. Tears don't exist. I want to play that game again. I played through 1 and 2 again, but I didn't play through 3. I forgot. And submissions. They're way too long. I gotta make those shorter. Oh, is this P tier? Their ass is doing no damage. I don't know if this is it. This is what Coney sings at karaoke night? You know how embarrassing that would be? Not even gaming night. People are singing like Ed Sheeran and Imagine Dragons and shit. And I go up and sing Snake Eater? That's humiliating. Don't look at me. Why is he looking at me? What is he doing? His ass is gazing. Huh? What is that flame attack? Everything else is long range, but that little itty bitty flame. Fire! Yeah, Hayate is not good, bro. Die! He said no cross-ups here! Fuck that shit! No cross-ups on this one. Yep, he's looking again. Yep, there he goes. Bro, Puppez, as soon as I saw him, I was like, that's easy, yeah. Any character that looks like that's got some goofy shit. Freezer Fortier Forma Super Goku. Now, there is a famous rule when it comes to DBZ characters in Salty Bed. I will not tell you what it is, but I will say you should ask your fellow chatters if you would like to save some points. All right? He's so Oh, they're both DBZ. Never mind. They're both DBZ, so it's bad either way. That's fine. Oh, there it is. What tier is this? Oh, I don't know. I don't be looking at the tiers. I just look at, I think about what my heart says. How strong should these characters be, you know? Mobile betting is fucked. Oh, is it? Do it fast. Oh, never mind. That should be quick. Okay. How mobile are you? Are you, like, super mobile? Or just, like... Because I feel like mobile isn't that slow. No way this Frieza doesn't have a Mexi Beam. Can you not use that term in my chat? This is an inclusive space. This is your only warning. Don't you ever say that again. Latinx Beam. Now that's progressive. That is approved scientific terminology? A Mexi Beam? Frieza is so little, bro. His ass is so tiny. What is he gonna do, bro? Did Salty Bet Mexican means anything light, high damage, Canadian means low. Oh, wait, really? Okay, never mind. That's a Mexi Beam. Never mind. I was thinking, okay, I'll allow it then. If it means we get the shit on Canada, sure. By the way, Goku wins. Why'd you guys think Frieza won? That's crazy, because he was tiny. L. He was so small, you thought he wouldn't get hit. Crazy Cook versus Ken Masters. Ooh, the Ken? The real Ken? I don't know why he's 11. Is that Ken Master fucking 9? No, it's not. That's 11. Oh, God. What is he from? What is that guy from? What the f... Crazy Cook wins? He has a meter and, like, a weapon thing here? I don't know what that is. Chat, what's good? I made myself dinner. You schmuck! You dumb fool, you buffoon. Don't make dinner. Order dinner with Factor and then make it in the microwave with chef-prepared meals delivered right to your door. Itch the past few days. I have a craving. A hunger. And this hunger can only be sated. By bananas. Oh my god. I think there'd be an update. So stupid. Why is there an update on Banana Mania? Doubter's Night? Shut up. Maybe not. I'm kind of good. Not bad. Right? See, that was why the monkey were in the... That's why the monkey was in the title. That Mario punch still makes me laugh. I keep getting jump scared by the Mario punch. Wait till you see this title. Wait. Oh, come on. Okay. I was gonna play Fall Guys, but apparently you can't do, like, there's no way to do, there's no way to do, like, a Super Mario Maker style, like, where you go through people's levels, probably because it's brand new. I would kill for that. That would be so fun. Well, connect to the internet, you can check with your friends. Connect to the internet, I guess. I don't really care to, but I should do Sans Fight. You can share level codes. Yeah, but that's such a process, right? I'd rather just, like, get thrown into a... Damn, this is made with Unity. But playing a Monkey Ball game made with Unity feels a little weird. Makes me a little nervous. Super Monkey Ball! I love Super Monkey Ball. Random Falls Guys levels would go? That's what I'm saying, dude. If I could just play random levels made by people in the same way that you play Super Mario Maker, that would be fantastic. So I think I already beat the main game, so I was just going to do, like, the real games. Is that missions? Does anyone know? People knew before. It's not missions, right? No one knows. Because it has, like, Monkey Ball 1, 2, 3, whatever, like, challenge. Ranking challenge. Party game. Is it ranking? Mission? Isn't it challenges? Main game time attack. I don't want to do time attacks. Challenge mode in main game. Got you. Thank you. I'll go Sonic. We go Sonic. Thank you, Chatter. Bless you. I think I go X. W. Did I seriously just miss Salty Bet again? A little bit too slow, viewer. A little bit too slow. Too bad. Show up early next time, dumbass. Ready? Did I already beat this? I know I beat the main game. No, I beat the main Banana Mania game. It was only 6 matches, don't worry. We'll do more another time, alright? Ready? Go! Didn't I beat this? I feel like I already beat this. This shit seems kind of easy. Well, fall out. I guess if I go the hard way. Ready? Go! Go for the red goal. I will. I don't know how we gamble on this, but I don't want to set it up. So one of you guys, mods, help me out here. Ready? Go! Oh my god. Thank god for chat. Thank god for chat. Oh my god. Thank you. Sincerely, thank you so much.
Never save him.
You saved my life.
Don't save him.
Holy crap.
Ruined it.
Can I interest you in a Factor roasted garlic chicken meal? Delicious, delivered right to our door and freely microwavable. Thank you for saying that. It would have been really bad if you said no. Because they're paying us. No, I'm full. I'm so full. Because I already had two today.
It's 10:30
and I already had 2 Factor meals today. So I'm full, you know. I simply couldn't. Yeah. Thank you, Sweet Pea.
But would you like me to return your meals to the fridge?
Could you, actually?
Because right. I figured that.
Can you carry all 8? They're heavy. There's a lot of food. You get a lot of value, actually, for these. Yeah. Thank you, Sweet Pea. Look at all the meals you get in your box of Factor. Mmm. Look at that. Yum, yum. He's a Factor fiend. I'm a Factor maniac. Thank you, honey. I appreciate it. Well, did you have to tell me something? Oh, you're just trying to scare me. Oh, how'd it go? Yeah? Good. Okay, we'll talk about it soon. If you're still up. Okay. Everybody say bye, Mal. She had an audition tonight. Ooh. She's trying to get a part in the Sound of Music. Ben, whoever told me to go for that goal, it's so easy. You thought I couldn't do it.
Ready?
Was that Juliet? Did you think that was my daughter? That just came in? How old do you think I am, Chatter? How old? I think I kissed my daughter on the lips. My fully grown adult daughter. I'm a fucking Tom Brady. Monkey Ball 1. I should go back. If I go back, does it go... Wait, was it segmented like Monkey Ball 1, 2, 3? Like... I wasn't paying attention. Can I do 2? 2 as a washing machine level. Let's do that. Because I think I did 1. Mal likes Super Monkey Ball, but she says Super Monkey Balls. And I've tried to get her to stop, but she won't. I know. It's so stupid. I know, but that's what she says. Mal is so much funnier than you. I know. She's my muse. She inspires me. Your wife is funny. I know. Stop saying that. You guys remember that one night she took over stream and played, what did she play? Pajama Sam? One night only? It was like 8 years ago, right? That was so long ago, yeah. What's crazy is that the Y in chat said what? Tutorupa said what? That's so crazy. Somebody who's been here forever didn't know. Yeah, dude. It was Pajama Sam. I think she played Snake Bird. Not Snake Bird. Snake Pass. That was it. Right?
Ready? Go!
What? Putt-putt, that's what you played. Yes. One night only stream. Oh, it's a W. Wait.
Fall out.
A W for will fall. What's a way to say die? Go. I've been waiting years for us to play Snake Bird again. Shut up. What's a way to say you died with a W? There's gotta be like a... Oh my god. Dude. How is this level 2?
Ready?
Wilted away, go. Wasted. I like that. I like that. Whoops! Wait, how is this level 2? Oh, wait. I can't. This is making me sick. Expert? Yeah, but expert, I thought it only was because it had more levels. I thought expert was the same, it just has more levels, right? Oh, that's in.
Okay. Ready, go!
If I just hold up, it's a W. Right? Oh no, I moved the camera.
Fall out!
Oh, I forgot about the helper function. No!
Ready, go!
I don't want the helper function. Cody, can I have Riz advice, please? I'm trying to play Monkey Ball! Oh. Oh.
Fall out. Ready, go!
Cody, can you add more frames? I'm gonna throw up. What does that mean? Oh. I want to die. Wait.
Fall
that didn't
out.
Land?!
Ready,
adds in
go.
1 second. Adds right now. Here they come. Coney has zero Riz anyway. I'm literally married. I literally have a child. That came from me. Why did I do that? I thought that was...
Ready, go.
I fucking hate Monkey Ball, dude. Okay. We go here. We go. Nope. Just... Nope. Just... Are you fucking kidding? Dude. Fall out. This is level 2.
Ready? Go.
Why is level 2 so hard?
I should
stream a game I'm good at.
Ready? Go.
Like, I never really thought about that. I don't stream any games I'm good at. You know what I mean?
Fall out.
Stream League?
Ready?
Yeah, that's what I should do. Stream League of Legends. The other night on my secret stream, Fall I played out. Valorant, and I wanted to die. I am so
Ready?
Bad at Valorant.
Go.
I am so fucking bad at that. Are you kidding?
Fall out.
I don't have the brain partition for Valorant. Like, I literally don't know how to, like, learn. Like, most games, when I play it, as I play it, I could go, ah. And I hit the rock smart, and I'm like, that's why I died. This is what I did wrong. In Valorant, it's like, oh, I that guy smoked, which cut off my... W. He smoked this area, and I didn't know he was over there, but then this other person hit this other line, and it's crazy.
Ready?
It's unbelievable.
Go.
Can't stand it. Oh, it's this one? Oh, I don't want to play monkey ball anymore.
Ready? Go.
Can't I turn this off? I forgot that I thought that I would be starting on the normal mode. Oh, wait, there's this. Well, well, well. Look at that. Okay, so it's up. Up. How do I know when it mixes? When do I...
Fall out. Ready, go.
I love monkey ball. Okay. Okay. One, two, three, four. Mix. One, two, three, four, mix. One, two, three, whoa! That was easier than I thought. Okay. That's not too bad. Perhaps Subula could keep count better. What's crazy is that a non-sub said that.
Ready?
That is crazy that you feel entitled to Subula. Despite not giving a dollar to the Coney stream. What makes you think Subula would even want to see you? Subula has been locked away for 10,000 years. 5 millennia. That I don't know why it's 10 millennia. It is a thank you, Monk HB. Don't do that. Thank you. Why did that happen immediately? Why did 3 people stop? What the fuck? That literally was instant. What the fuck was that? I think Subula should stay locked away. You're not going to get an argument from me, Chatter. I know you want me to be like, oh, no, I hope you... Thank you, Hobo in the corner. You don't have to do that. I think he is locked away for a long time. Guys, I'm doing gameplay. If I have a 900-viewer Subula, I'm going to be so sad.
Ready? Go!
Do not make me do a 500-viewer Subula. Do not do... I'm playing a video game. The viewers are dropping like flies. Oh, this sucks.
Fall out. Ready? Go.
Cody in 10 minutes. Oh, fell out. My belly is bursting. Shut up. I hate when I fall asleep to Cody and I wake up to fucking organ noises and screaming. My bad. Me too. That doesn't sound good, but it's very lucrative. I hope you understand. The children love Subula. I hope you get it.
Fall out. Ready?
I get it. I get it. I really do. The children, they longed for Subula. They longed for an ancient vampire to come out of his slumber from 10,000 years.
Ready? Go!
My bad, y'all. Yoop! Where's the exit? Oh! Okay. There we go. This I don't like the monkey ball Skrillex music. I'm not into this. Oh my god. Where the fuck is the exit? I'm gonna get sick.
Hurry up!
Shut up! What do you see this level? What do you mean, hurry up? No! I forgot. I did that before. Oh my god, dude.
Ready?
I always do that. It's fine. I can beat this fast. It's only like three levels. It's fine. Subula time? Literally, no. It hasn't popped yet. No. It's fine. It's only three levels. It's not that bad.
Go! Ready? Go!
What I don't understand is how do you get good at this part? You know what I mean? Like, how do I even aim that? I feel like I can't even aim that. I'm not kidding. Like, I know it's funny to say skill issue and everything, but how do you aim it?
Ready? Go.
Mini map? Yeah, but like it's. Oh, wait, I can just... like I'm aiming during. I'm aiming as I go, right?
Ready?
And I'm looking at the mini map. But it doesn't... I can't fully direct it. You know what I mean? Wait.
Fall out. Ready? Go!
It's just something you learn to do over time. Thank you, Chatter. Actually, an earnest, honest Chatter in the Coney Street. Oh, I win. No way. Okay. We made it. Thank you, kind Chatter. Oh, my God. Stop. Are you kidding? Yeah, I told you it wouldn't be that bad. You're so jittery. Stop being jittery. What do you mean jittery?
Ready? Go.
What is this level? What?
Fall out. Ready?
I wasn't here before. You got a different Fall exit last out. Time. Wait, the different exits go to different
Ready?
Levels?
Go.
Oh.
Fall out. Ready?
Chad,
go.
How do I... How would one...
Fall out. Ready? Go!
If one were to... try to get into this spot. Oh, okay. Oh, God! Stop! It's not funny. Stop. Enough. Stop. Sega. What the fuck? Stop this instant. Stop. I'm getting it. Fuck me. Who's moving this? I never really thought of Monkey Ball as like a dimension of hell. But it kind of would be, right? Like, if you think of it like a human in the ball, this would definitely be one of the points. I can't believe it. Oh, we're in. Okay. You know what I mean? Like, imagine being that human, right? The human in the ball. Just, the ball would be just be coked in vomit. Coked? Caked in vomit. excrement.
Fall out.
Eternal suffering, yeah.
Ready? Go!
All coked up? No. You don't get coke in hell. Switch. Let's get it. Yoop! 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 Oh, okay, too slow.
Fall out. Ready?
I had to tell my friend what a yoop was the other day. I met a friend that I hadn't seen for a long time, and we went out to Korean barbecue, me and a small group. And I reached across the table for the steamed egg, and I went, yoop! And I thought he knew what it was, and he did not. I was like, you don't know that Braid video? He was like, wait, Soulja Boy played Braid? I'm like, I know you know this. Did he go, what? Hold on, I have to count this. One, two, three, reverse! Oh my god. One, two, three, reverse. One, two, three, reverse!
Fall out. Ready?
$30,000 bananas gives you jump, right? I'm not jumping, old pussy-ass mechanic. Oh, I don't know how to play monkey ball-ass mechanic. Two, three, yoop. One, two, three, four. It's four. It's four. It's actually four. It's four. It's four. It's four, actually. Alright, I got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yoop! 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 4 yoops. Got it. Subula could do this. Well, we'll never know. He's been dead for 10,000 years! Thinking power of a goldfish. Shut up. This game's really hard. It just doesn't look like it.
Goal!
You better be nice before I make you throw up. I could cast a vomit spell on 1,200 people. Well, hold on. How many people are there? On 400 Ready? People right now.
Go!
The number just hasn't updated yet.
I'm the best!
I guess you did end up playing Fall Guys on my
Fall
Out. Omega Wolf. That's funny, yeah.
Ready? Go!
Dude, Monkey Ball Fall Guys with like 50 people. Why did nobody... How would you control it?
Ready, go.
I think we've spotted the issue. On Kickstarter, that would go into the risks and complications. I think you're right. That would be quite troublesome. Alright.
Ready? Go!
Wait, if you fall, you go into the boiling water? Oh my god, I'm in a pot! I didn't know that! Who's cooking Sonic? Dr. Bad Boon? What a stupid name.
Fall out. Ready? Go!
Why are you colon D-ing me? Dr. Bad Boon is a stupid name. It's not Super Baboon Ball. Get in there. You! Bro, where is the gate? I'm dead.
Fall out.
Shut up. I hate the helper feature.
Ready? Go!
Oh, helping ass. Yoop! Oh, no. Wait, did I... Where am I going? Yes! Roll, please. Roll. Oh, my God. The goal launches? The goal launches. Fuck me. Gonna you I love it, you. I love it. I love you, bro. So, if you missed the first part of the stream, everybody, stream will not be tomorrow, I don't think. Unless I decide to do it. I don't know. Maybe I will. Because I'm streaming Friday instead. We're streaming Fall Guys. Friday? You mean the day Breath of the Wild 2 comes out? Yep, I forgot. I forgot that was out that day. So, but hey, I'll be on... Wait, I just realized... Alpharab might not have realized that. Uh-oh. He's gonna be like, oh, I actually had to play the game for stream. Oh, no. Fall out. Don't remind him? Oh, I won't. Ready? I will not tell him that. 500 viewers stream, I'll be here. God bless. My strongest soldiers. Oh my god. Are you... I'm in the fish pot.
Ready?
Good lord, dude. Pop Subula on Friday? During Twitch Rivals? During Twitch Rivals, they regularly, like, pop into streams. Could you imagine? What's going on here? Oh! It seems this contestant is role-playing as a vampire. I wonder if there's a vampire skin. There has to be in Fall Guys, right? Dude, this is so miserable. Coney is, imagine having to be that person. Actually, unironically, and this is not a joke or a bit, I got asked to commentate this Fall Guys event, which is how I knew it was happening. They're like, hey, do you want to commentate it? And I was like, sure, here's my rate. And they said, nope, we want to go with someone else. And I was like, okay, I'll compete in it. I'll make money that way. Hell yeah. Now, the problem is, I wonder how real this Fall Guys shit is now. You know what I mean? Like, the tryhards aren't what they used to be. Or are they, right?
Fuck.
What's your rate if you're comfortable sharing? Oh, Chatter. That's rather uncouth. Don't you think that's a little bit tasteless? $10 billion an hour? I will tell you when I make a tell-all autobiography. I'm only half joking. When I'm done with this esports shit, if I ever get to be, I'm telling everybody everything. I'm going out with a bang. What's your rate if you're uncomfortable sharing? Oh, in that case. Pay transparency? Hey, if I worked a corpo job or a esports industry job, absolutely. Casting? This shit is cutthroat. Breakneck. That's not the right word. That shit is you just going with the PM. What's your rate? What's your budget? And then you both just stand there. Oh. please. No way. Wait. We go green? We go green here. Dude, this is... How does anybody complete this? Now, I'm lucky enough that I have a stream, and I'm pretty happy. Things are good. I'm doing very well. I'm doing very... You know, I'm fine. That's thanks to all of you. Bless up. Thank you. But if commentary was my main gig, oh, dude. I would have to be very secretive. Me? Even you, Chatter. Yep. Even you. Your humble $5 a month. helps me from having to... Oh my God! Helps me from having to denigrate myself in commentary budget talks. Bless up. No. 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 No, dude. No. No. Come on. How does anyone do this?
Hurry up! 10!
Don't retry. Don't retry. Don't retry.
9, 8, 7, fall out!
Cody, if your hourly rate was your stream key, how much would you charge per hour? Dude, if my hourly rate was my stream key, you would never see me again. See, I make that joke, but I don't think that's true. I actually have a lot of fun streaming. Cody, I am so sick. Please beat this level. Everybody in chat is just deathly ill. Hold on. Oh my God! Thanks, Michigan. Love the state. Just kidding. Hate that state. Dude, how do you win? You have to like bounce on the outside. Dude!
Hurry up! 10, 9, 8.
Oh, it's in.
7, go!
There. Did you see it try to launch me at the end? You son of a bitch! You see it try to. No, 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 not me.
Ready?
Unbelievable.
Go.
I remember zigzag slope. First you zig. Yep. And then you zag. And then you zig. A zag too
long. Fall out. Ready? Go.
How am I only on level 7? I should have done it. I thought expert was the same as normal. It just put you on a different kind of level. You know what I mean? Why'd I do that?
Fall out. Ready?
Should I have done
go.
Normal? Bro is zigging and zagging. WWW's in chat. WWW.
Ready?
Tower. Bro, the exit's right there. Oh. Oh. W streamer, W lifestyle. What the? I could have beat that, though. That was close. Okay, I get a little dizzy. Okay. We go... softly.
Hurry up!
I can't
nine,
stand that lady.
Eight,
I want to mod her
seven,
out of the game.
Fall out.
Yeah, I gotta ready, get her. I gotta go. Get her out of the game, man. I don't like her. Even if I could get Sonic, at least he's like encouraging. You know what I mean? Okay, so if we go further, maybe if we drop right. Oh, that is, well. Okay, we go. Oh, I forgot I had to slow down. Wait. No, no, no. No, don't follow. Hurry up.
Fall
I'm
out. Never mind. Ready? Go!
That looked great. What, you think going fast? Wait, actually, because then I get the... Oh!
Oh!
Balling!
Ready? Go!
A-bet, baby. I mean, I don't just run, right?
Fall out!
That seems rather foolish.
Ready, go. Fall out. Ready, go.
I think it's a full send. Unlucky.
Fall out.
I think it's a full send. You just got to get the right timing. By the way, just so you guys know, the DK video is up to... Okay, it's a full send, but you gotta pull back at the end. Got it. So the DK video is number 7 on the channel overall, and it's number 7 with a bullet. I've already chosen the next topic, but I'll have to consult with someone. This next topic is something I'm not an expert about, but I've already decided it, so... I wish I could tell the Brawl Heads, like, what it is. I have a bunch that I want to do, but still getting Evo robbed? Not yet. No. Oh, that was a bonus. Whoops. Wait, what? Did I go back? No. What is this song? Oh, good heavens. Good heavens. What?
Fall out.
The kid just said, fuck you. Why'd it do that? Oh, yeah? Alright, there's a drop here. Let's just go down.
Fall out.
This is so disoriented. Well, I'm landing on this, and usually there's a button around that you could hit to make it stop doing that shit. Right? Is it behind the gate? It's behind the second portal down below. Oh, what the fuck? Backseating monkey ball. Things are dire. This is just a puzzle level, then. Enter the vomitorium. We've been expecting you. I'm still gonna die.
Hurry up! 10.
What do you mean, hurry
nine,
up?
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ah! Time over. Ready? Go!
I yelp because it would be funny to yelp. It's funny when you're loud. Smart. Ah, a wise decision. Come on. I hate puzzle levels, bro. I could have just figured that. Oh no. The exit's moving away. Please.
Hurry up! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
How? Wait. I'm going for it.
5, 4, fall out!
I gotta play a game I'm good at on stream, bro. There's gotta be one. And not League. Stop being a bitch and go diagonal. I'm scared! You son of a bitch.
Ready,
you're good at that
go.
Little pizza game you like. I hate that you said that. I hate that you said that. You sound like my wife. Little pizza game. She never called it that. Juliet called it Pizza Game, and she got so excited when I went to go play it. Dentist in chat? That's funny. Come on. Whoa. Oh! Oh, it's in. Oh, no. That'll stay close, though, right?
Hurry up! 10, fall out! Ready, go!
Oh! Kind of Sonic Mania? Actually, it is. What?
I have no interest in Liga, but I'd like to watch Kami play Liga. I want to see a new side of him and study him.
It's not good. Not good. I'm a different person. Me and Liga, I'm like Edward Cullen in Twilight. You couldn't handle me. Not safe for you.
Ready?
I'm too strong.
Go!
You're impossibly strong and incredibly
Fall
toxic.
Out. Ready? Go!
Never make analogies again? Never? It's like my favorite thing to do.
Fall out.
I just watched that series
Go.
Again. It's so fucking funny. So, unfortunately, my wife was in that sort of perfect time in her life to be enraptured by the, you know, by the vampire movie and the books. So she's a big Twilight fan. Lee got me misbehaving. It got me acting unwise, truly. The shit I be saying? Not good. Hey guys, so it's 28.91.
Ready?
If any of you guys have a Twitch Prime available, please use it, because at 2,900 subs, I will turn the stream off immediately. I would really appreciate it if you guys could release me from this torture. I'll stream tomorrow. You'll see me tomorrow anyway. So 2,900 and the stream is off. If you have a Prime, let's give it a shot. It's free. Don't you need to finish the bounty? I did. Oh, you mean the Men's Warehouse? I'll do that Sunday. That's a Smash stream. I'll get viewers then. 2,900 subs if you stream the entire 60 levels. What? I don't think I could ever do that. My ass is bouncing. I think I made
Hurry
it.
Hurry up! Just... 10! Fall out! Ready?
Aren't you not streaming tomorrow? I might! I...
Fall out! Much.
I guess! Did you? Like IRL? Fellas, surely there's one Prime. How did nobody have a Prime? Maybe you guys don't know what Twitch Prime is. So Twitch Prime is a way to subscribe for free. It's below the stream. And if you just go... It's just below the stream. And it says subscribe. But there's actually a checkbox that you hit that says subscribe for free. And if you go there, you have to subscribe for free. I looked away for 1 second.
Fall out. Ready, go!
The first call to actions are critically missing. I think the problem is monkey ball streams are all the people who are subbed or people who will not pay. There is no foot traffic in the Super Monkey Ball stream, except for Metcalf. There it is, thank you. I should start a Kickstarter for Prime. Big ups. Thank George. This shit is bouncing. Thanks, Keto. I'm politely asking.
Goal!
Phew. Thanks, I Swim Fly. Damn, Pink Fresh had to be gifted a sub. Call it. He's got a kid on the way. I'll let it slide.
Ready,
but as soon as that baby's out,
go.
Bring your ass right back here. I don't know what. That was easy, actually. That was mad easy. I will say that's actually one of my least favorite things that people do in chats. Like, if I popped into EE's chat and people are like, Cody not subbed, eyes emoji, I fucking hate that. I hate it when people do that. But it's funny that I did it just now. That's really funny.
Ready? Go!
Thanks, Kid Scott. I resubscribed, but it didn't do anything. Oh, it did! I think I'm two away now.
Fall out.
I think I'm two away from freedom. Almost 2,900. We can do it, guys. We're almost there. What the fuck is this?
Fall out.
What?
Ready? Go!
What the fuck? What the fuck is this?
Fall out.
Huh?
Ready? Go.
Weren't we just at 3,500? I swear we were. No. Heavens no. I think my highest ever is 32? 33 maybe? What happens at 3,000, though? What a funny message sent by Habitful. Yeah. Ever care you? Wait. I don't have a fun plan for 3K. I don't. You don't have to do it. You don't have to. You don't have to do that, Habitful. Not the casual, iconic Habitful 100. You don't have to do it. I don't have a funny plan. Oh, is that 2,900? Oh, wait, no, 2,899. Never mind. Yeah, I thought that was 2,900. Yeah, I'm just 29, but it should update, right? Like in a second, it should. Probably, like, it's taking a bit. I don't know why it's taking so long to update. I don't. The factor number went up? No, it didn't. I've been shilling too many food things. Also, HelloFresh is next month, so that will be coming soon. What if no one subs? I don't know what's happening. This is supposed to be... This isn't even like a bit or anything. That shit is stuck. That joint's at $28.99. I don't know what to say. That shit's just...